Yellow diamonds in the light. As a shadow crosses my.
It's a hot video.
What it takes to come alive.
We better wait for the chorus, eh?
Oh yeah, you gotta give it to him.
Yeah.
In memory of our first podcast.
Flashbacks to his first stripper.
And the cat house here.
Throwing loonies.
$10 shooters!
Next to the stage, we welcome Cinnamon.
Did you get a poster from that one?
Magnet.
All right, we'll shut down that song.
What a song, though.
Isn't it?
Kind I like that one. It bangs.
Song of the season one of the Bachelor podcast.
That's a hot track.
Well, like, if you look at the big picture of it all, the two people we have on right now did find love in a hopeless place.
Is 4620 really that hopeless?
150% hopeless.
Okay, like it was, like, for Dustin, it was pretty hopeless because, like, I was the focal point of the thing, and he still found love in a hopeless place.
He just slid in.
As Allie being one of the contestants.
But and I got to say this really early on. He put himself out there a lot more than you did, which didn't make
sense. The minute that podcast aired, the only comments that I got was one word, hijack. Hijack, hijack, hijack. And I wasn't disagreeing with folks.
Maybe the system that we did where Wacey didn't get to come on and actually talk
my
to
my mom
any of the
had
girls.
More airtime than me.
Title of your sex tape.
We've changed the format this year, so we have a bit
of a different show. Ted, why don't you walk us through what we're going to go through today?
Well, it's really similar to last year, except hopefully it works this time for you.
Bigger
and
budget.
Not just Dustin. Yeah, bigger budget.
Bigger budget, better screening process for the candidates.
Yeah, we actually had
everyone else is in a relationship, so they can't steal the girl.
That was wise.
Right? Well, John's here.
Oh,
yeah, but John's not he's not a host, though.
You know,
but look at him, lurking. He's lurking in the weeds.
If Sean was smart,
he's lurking behind the
cactuses,
ready to pounce.
Yeah. So what's going on here, though? First segment, we got last year's one of our co-hosts.
Can we say winners? Like in
winners? You're the only Bachelor that's the winner.
Last year's winners?
Technically the winners. Technically the winners, Dustin and Allie.
Thank you.
Hey,
so
everyone.
I have my first question for you guys.
How am I on the hot seat now?
Well, this is because we need to update
the hijacked the show. Now you got to answer the bell.
All right.
So walk us through the first steps of you guys like getting together. Like,
wow.
Did you like notice her at the podcast? Like, hey, like, it's the kind of shit I like.
Do you know what? If you go back in the podcast and listen, I got pretty enthusiastic when she was talking about being a naughty nurse.
Yeah. And we'll just go back to that clip right here.
All right,
we have a clip.
Naughty nurse on set.
Oh,
Dusty's Trail coming at you with
Dusty's
a couple
Trail
questions.
From the naughty nurse from Canmore. Yep. Why are you here? What brings you to this competition?
I just really want to prove that not all girls from Hannah, I'm a Nickelback, are destined to break Wacey's heart.
Still such a good sound.
That was the best clip.
Oh, dear.
I've been working on that one for a while that day.
So
sounds
good.
Pretty scripted. But
And then I faked cardiac arrest during the interview as
don't
well.
Don't worry. We have that one, too, actually.
What's one thing that nobody would know about you that would really set you apart from these other people, these women that are here?
I'm damn good at mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
Tick.
Yep. Tick.
Oh, I'm having cardiac arrest.
And
tick, tick,
Dusty's
tick.
Down.
And I would say that is when I found love in a hopeless place.
And is that a true statement that I'm damn good at it?
Oh.
Oh, the truth comes out.
Cheers.
So I want to get it from your side of the coin, too. Like, so how did the process of Dusty approaching you?
How long did he wait?
Well, the next day, I got friend request.
Oh, really?
Friend request LinkedIn? Dustin Edwards, Instagram, new follow Dustin Edwards. And I was like, okay, this is cool.
It was an aggressive approach.
Was it the next day or the same day?
Did you mail her a letter as well?
Were you the thank you note?
Were you doing this like while you're interviewing her? Just like, oh, yeah, just on your phone at the same time?
Do you know what it was I saw Wacey give her the first impression cactus, and I just knew. I just knew that was my opportunity. She wasn't going to get the rose. She was going to be vulnerable and sad.
You knew that she wasn't going to get... How? What?
It's a
was sad when she didn't get the rose. I seen the look in her eye.
Oh,
and I thought,
I was my devastated.
Okay.
Dustin digs a chick holding the cactus. I get it. Pretty common.
Right? And so I added her on all social channels.
And then messaged me.
We were playing in the head hockey tournament.
Stop talking. Okay, I want to hear her talk.
Your version is a little bit swayed. But yes, you added me, and then seen you at the Hannah hockey tournament, seen you guys won.
Yeah.
Hey, champions.
Hey, let's go.
I scored I made a couple of big moves. Face-off win.
Yeah, just like sidebar story.
The best
move of that whole tournament was, it was 30 seconds left against the Hannah team that always beats us. Dusty's like, he's playing defense. I'm taking the draw. He wins the draw back to one of our defensemen. The guy banks it off the glass, empty net goal. We win the game. It was I was fully torqued after that.
Okay, so continue.
It was so awesome.
So we win.
So you guys won. Seen it on the Instagram because you followed me. And then my stepdad genuinely wanted to know who they beat because we know that that's the rival team of Hannah as well.
So she says.
The team you beat. And so I replied to your Instagram and said, hey, who'd you guys end up playing or who'd you beat? And you said, and then we didn't talk probably for another 3 weeks. And then you took someone else on a date. And then
you said, you're like, they're going to talk about that.
I'm talking about it, so I'm the one.
Let's air the laundry. Let's go.
Well, she wasn't biting the hook that I was dangling.
You know, she slid into your DMs, dude.
No, he slid in first. That's what got our conversation started.
So someone else who was here that day on the podcast also was biting my hook. Or she was here watching.
Just fangirling.
We don't have to bring it up.
we need to do
that. I think we do. That's amazing. You got so much action from this podcast, and Wacey got dumped in the end.
I did.
I'm so happy right now.
So fast forward a few months, and you guys are together. You're happy.
A few months.
We actually go on our first date at Eggy Days, and we come back here together with Ted.
To HQ.
I want to talk about Invermere, how that went down when we were... Allie, can you please tell that story?
So I was in Canmore, and Dustin was in Invermere with the boys trip, and he's texting me all weekend. Like, this is when we were consistently talking. He's texting me all weekend, perfect grammar, punctuation, genuinely interested in my day-to-day activities of that weekend. And I text him, I said, you know, if this is a boys thing, like, it's okay if you don't text me, that's fine. No, I'm fine. Well, aren't you drinking? Meanwhile, I've got Wacey, I've got Ted on Snapchat. I didn't have Dustin. And I'm seeing all these videos of Dustin not coherent. So I finally told Dustin, like, by the way, Wacey's sending me Snapchats of you incoherent.
Not mastering gravity.
I went to the dollar store, bought prescription glasses, the highest ones, wore them to the hockey game, couldn't see.
Well, a funny
sidebar. That's my alter ego, Jiminy Gibble.
A funny sidebar for that weekend was we didn't play until Friday night at 9:30 p.m., and a truckload of us left on Thursday at noon.
We dusted a 40 of Long Island iced tea before Dead Man's Flat.
Yeah, that's a recipe. Yeah.
It was eating through the cups. It was stiff and acidity.
It also ate through your stomach.
Yeah,
I didn't eat through the walls.
And he got gut rot after.
I had an ulcer.
Our first date, Dustin couldn't eat because he had gut rot from the Long Islands at Invermere. And as per the first podcast, I hate eating on a first date, if anyone remembers that.
Let's talk about our second date.
Worked out.
She comes to Drumheller.
Let's talk about the first date. First,
she gets hammered drunk with the scouts of our hockey team, and within 3 hours is laying on my living room floor. She's like, the roof is spinning. That was date two.
And I haven't drank since.
That's how you knew it was going to be good, eh?
Yeah. I was like, oh my God. So we've had a good run.
I don't think it
was. So now, like, I would, like, what are the odds of you guys making a joint Facebook account?
Oh,
well,
please.
I know that it was suggested a few times.
I know,
by the podcast.
This has been a topic of the pod before. Well, just like, so here's my argument for it. Like, you guys both post the same photos.
I don't know if you
see them on, and I see them on two different channels. Like, I see them on Instagram story, Snapchat story,
Twitter,
Snapchat,
LinkedIn.
Yeah, I just like
Nexopia.
I get an email notification every time you guys post a selfie. It's like, okay, like maybe if we just put this all into one thing.
Wacey, we took, after your last podcast, I really took this into consideration, and if you haven't been noticing, we've not been posting any of the same photos.
She takes one with her right hand, and I take one with my left hand.
Exactly, it's completely different.
I just gotta get in, though. If you guys were to do a joint Facebook, could you wear what you're wearing in now?
Yes.
Like, just to paint the picture of Dustin.
Yes.
He looks like Uncle
who
Rico.
Whose name goes first?
Well,
in the joint account.
We're actually going to call the account Dusty and Allie Trail.
Trails.
The trails.
When, that's because when two trails become one, it's just a trail.
True.
Philosophical moment.
When two become one.
It's like the title of a song. Like a lyric from a song. When two trails become one, they become a trail.
I'd pay 99 cents for that.
So needless to say, I think, you know, just coming full circle here, we were lucky to find love on this very podcast. I don't know where I'd be without it.
Was that a bit of a sniffle?
He's tearing up a little bit?
He's crying.
Yeah, he's crying for sure.
You should have heard Dustin's practice to this, which I knew he wasn't going to say.
In the mirror. Please say it was in the mirror with that shirt on. No pants.
I want to...
Well, you should have seen what he was wearing this morning. He was going to wear his Dumb and Dumber orange suit.
Oh.
I'm wearing a Hawaiian shirt, full button.
You got an awesome Austin Matthews mustache.
Yeah.
I bought you that shirt.
Thank you.
You look really good.
You look a lot like a gym teacher I wouldn't trust.
Come to my van.
It's the mustache.
Yeah.
You just need like some short shorts on.
Yeah.
Or not. Also.
Well, high socks.
It's like to round out the look.
But, yeah, no, I came here as a host a year ago and left as a lover.
But yeah, Dustin's big thing before, he's like, I'm gonna go on there and I'm gonna say that yes, we met at podcast, but we are destined to meet each other. So I know that I would have met you regardless of podcast or not. And there's this big speech in the vehicle. I'm like, okay.
And instead he came on here and said he saw you holding a cactus and fell in love.
Exactly.
Yeah. I'd say
exactly.
He nailed it.
Yeah.
Hey, right?
Yeah.
So, Allie, we'll leave you with this.
All
Can
right.
you offer me some advice heading into today?
I don't know. Be picky.
The ladies are listening right now. They're all at attention over there.
Yeah.
I don't be real. Pick somebody that's genuine and will love you and take care of you.
I haven't cried in like 12 years.
I don't have this
isn't making it happen. That's
hey,
for sure.
If I can offer you something, find a girl who will trim your toenails for you like Allie
no,
trims
I know. Hell. Wow. I hate feet.
Okay, she's a foot nurse.
The worst thing I've lucky. Heard today.
I do a lot of things for Dustin that I wouldn't do for anyone else.
And with that, thanks for coming on.
This segment brought to you by Horse and Maine.
Well, I appreciate that advice.
Thank you guys for letting us find love.
In a hopeless place.
And this panel of podcast will probably be the host of our wedding.
Ooh.
Yeah. So, hey, wait.
Don't.
It's not over yet.
Don't.
I got some in my sock.
Hey, you guys are getting married soon, aren't you? Hey, Teddy?
Who, Dustin and Allie?
No, I was thinking you.
Eventually.
Oh. Teddy got a Montana Silversmith's ring for her.
Yeah.
Trade right. show discount.
Thanks to Dustin and Allie for being on segment number one. We'll be back.
Ted made commission on the
interviews.
Wedding ring you bought.
Interviews after this. First contestants.
Ted makes commission on the wedding ring you bought for himself. Falling behind. I picked my own song.
He is, you know what? If there is anyone who is a mighty fine man, it's Wacey Anderson.
Oh, wow. Are we supporting him this year? Is that like...
Hey, well,
it's safe to say last year we didn't do
I'd say last year's theme was the roast of Wacey featuring four women.
We had to get that...
And my mom.
reluctantly,
who roasted him the most?
Oh, reluctantly, man. I think the contestants also thought it was a roast on how it turned out.
It's so, funny story.
It might still be a roast.
When you put the thing on Everything Cowboy, like the application process, my mom called me. She's like, hey, what's going on? I'm like, not much, just like...
Anything
just
new?
Just like hanging out. And I told her what was going on, and she's like, so you going to need me to do anything with The Bachelor this year? And I'm like, no.
Nope.
You're not invited anymore,
she
Mom.
She did enough.
Oh.
I think we need to talk about a year in review.
Year in review, you know, of Wace? Wace's year in review?
How did Wacey end up at Bachelor 2?
Three things that have gone right for you this year.
We're gonna
and go. Hey.
And if you only got one, that's fine.
Okay, so starting out how we ended up here, we were on our way home from Polkville, I think, Teddy and I, and it was like 2 a.m. and we were just visiting. And he's like, I just recently got broken up with, and I was in a bad place.
Again.
Yeah, again.
How many
rinse,
times?
Repeat.
How many times would that, was that year?
Every relationship I've ever been in, I've been broken up with. Whatever. Not a big deal.
It's definitely a big deal.
Wait, so you're an Iron Man.
Man, we've had 3 breakup parties, me and Preston.
I can't take any more breakup parties. They are so hard.
Was that the second or third one for the year, though?
For 2019, that was... Yeah.
Was that 2 or 1?
That was my 3rd of the year.
You
Your 3rd of the
three
year?
3 times? Oh, wow. Since last February?
No, it was only twice. No, it was only twice. Okay. I got dumped through twice. Twice.
Okay.
Yeah, twice. Sarah and Megan.
Twice. 2 breakups.
So was there a breakup with last year's winner of The Bachelor?
There was kind of like a
mutual well,
what's
pardon?
That called no. when someone dies and they haunt you? I think it's ghosting.
She's was still
it,
alive.
It was just like, yeah, it didn't work out. So I guess you could say 3 times. But anyways... So Teddy and I are on our way home from Pollockville, and he's like, "Hey man, like, if you're single, Super Bowl weekend."
Is
again,
that
like,
how Teddy talks?
Late. That's my. It's late at night. That's when it's 2 a.m.
Teddy's 2 a.m. voice is
driving
so
down the road, looking for snacks.
Okay, that's another story. That's a really funny story. So
that's one of my things. That's one of my things that went right.
You know, Wacey held up a red rooster in Wilkie, Saskatchewan.
Okay, so first story. So Ted's like, "Hey, if you're still single this time of year, like, will you do the Bachelor again?" I'm like, "Yep." So he shook on it and he tweeted it. So here I am. Okay, like moving into things
that was in July. That was some foresight.
Teddy's Twitter just has hold over your life.
It's been set. It's in words. It's writing. It's public.
It's on Twitter.
Yeah, it's put out the characters. Yeah. So then. Some things that went right, that's one of the things. So Eddie and I, we're on our way to Watcher, Saskatchewan to work a rodeo. Mm-hmm. I pick him up in Bymore, Alberta. So we drive, we cut across through like Provost and Wilkie and stuff to get to Saskatoon. And it's family day weekend.
Easter.
And
Easter
it's probably
weekend.
Late,
Easter
right?
Weekend. Easter weekend, and it's really late out, and we're like dying. Like, we need snacks now.
We haven't ate since 6 p.m. in Bymore.
Yeah, in Bymore. Haven't ate since we had a beef on a bun. So we're going... No snacks anywhere.
We stop in every town.
Provost,
every vending machine.
Wilkie. Eddie had $2.50 in change. We stop at Wilkie, and there's a pop machine. He got an iced tea for us to share. So it's like 2:30 in the morning. We pull into Bigger, his hometown, and the liquor store's open, and we get snacks, and we made it.
They had jerky, and we lived.
I remember dying. Like, Eddie was
the great famine of 2019.
Yeah, the great potato chip famine of 2019.
Okay, I just want to be clear that this is one of the 3 best things that happened to you.
If that is one of his best, that tells you what his year was like.
Okay,
I'm worried again.
So here, no, wait. Okay, here's.
I mean,
here's
this isn't meant to be a roast.
No. Here's the thing.
Go ahead.
2019 was a fairly tough year. Not gonna lie, but I mean, it was good though. I had a lot of fun times. Made some new friends.
You have friends?
Yeah.
He moved out?
I moved out. I got my own place.
He doesn't live in the basement anymore.
Finally left mom and dad's house.
Of the Bachelor Studios.
Yeah, I got my own downtown. That's a win. That's
recently,
really cool.
You have 3 towels.
You won the Hannah hockey tournament.
I got 4.
4 towels.
4 towels.
Yeah. Won Hannah.
Won the Hannah tournament. Finally.
Got snacks. Moved out. That's pretty good. That's pretty sweet, man.
You're still doing good in school.
I'm still in school.
Your hair still looks great.
I haven't dropped out of school yet.
No Bradley Cooper hair this year, though. Is that going to play a difference in this?
I was really close to growing my hair out again.
For this reason?
No, just because I wanted to.
It looks good.
Thanks. But yeah, no, things are good.
New glasses.
Where's some new glasses? I got some prescription sunnies, which are lights out.
Where are you at from here ago weight-wise? You slimmed down?
No, I'm probably either up 5 or about the same.
Okay.
That's been there.
Teddy just a little pinch test there.
That's been there.
Me, personally, I'm up about 10, I'm probably thinking.
The ladies want to know.
Is that 150 now? Or?
I fluctuate. I think I'm up to
my BMIs evened out. Mm.
So here's the question. What's the over-under on there being a third Bachelor podcast?
Honestly, it just matters how many people listen. That's pretty much.
We're just doing it for the ratings.
If Teddy gets ratings again, he's just going to kibosh the relationship.
No, if anything, if Wacey's... in a happy, loving relationship in 2021, we'll do an episode of The Bachelorette with one of the contestants that doesn't win.
We'll commit
to do one of these.
Here's
shows
to hoping.
Every Bachelorette. every Valentine's Day.
This is the year. I'm not leaving here unless you go.
I'm just waiting for Teddy's tweet. Bachelor 3.
Season 3. Will Wacey find love this time? People are not, I guess, to a point where people don't even apply anymore. Like, this guy's undateable.
Well, how many dates did you have you gone on this year?
Ugh.
Because I know you've been heavy on the dates lately.
Watch how many? Me tiptoe around the tulips.
20?
Like from last time to this time?
I think it's safe to say that he's been on dates.
He's my last girlfriend?
Yeah, let's not put a number on it.
Why don't we just say he's been on dates? And Wacey has been doing really good as a friend of Wacey's, I guess.
Preston's my best friend, so I confide in him a lot. So he's seen me at my worst.
And I tell him he's my friend. And I don't confide in him at all.
Friend of the show.
But I definitely can say that he's grown. He's changed. He actually has what's called a normal wall, where previously he just like, let's fall in love and you can hurt me quick.
Yeah. Shed a lot of tears.
As Michael Scott would say, I'm ready to get hurt again.
Well, with that said,
go.
Let's go. Just what would she say if they ever tried coming on to her? They know it's never gonna work.
I don't want to work this one very good.
Oh shit.
Comes the next contestant. Is that your hand? Oh my.
I fucking love Nickelback.
I've never wanted to hear Nickelback sing more. Just because you're trying to sing over it, though.
Man, it's part of the plot. People love my karaoke.
I've never read that anywhere.
Don't even say that. We've had people compliment my
people
karaoke.
Have commented on it on Twitter. I don't know if they've said they love it, but
semantics.
They've said that they have heard it.
Okay, so off the record, we were just breaking down my outfit. For those that can't see me, I'm wearing a
you're lucky if you
black.
Can't see him.
Yeah, it looks like a navy
blue
sweater.
Thankful you can't see him.
I have some purple corduroy pants on. So
I'm actually gonna paint this a little bit better. Is that navy blue?
It's your sweater, so
I don't remember getting it. There's a recent giveaway there. There's lint on it. That's probably the best part so far. The pants. They're skin tight corduroy maroon pants.
They're not skin tight.
At the start of his package. Like, buddy,
Levi Strauss.
They are so tight. I can see moles on your legs right now. They're so tight. You couldn't fit water in those pants. But my question is that earlier you said I was out in the store looking for maroon pants.
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
okay, so here's how I procured these pants.
Nobody looks for
okay.
Pants.
Here, let me explain myself. I'm getting attacked again. So here, I needed to buy some new pants.
I set out
to get some new pants. I was like, hey, I would like to have some maroon pants. Instead of just your regular jean color.
That's still not
so
a thing.
They were burgundy, now they're maroon.
So I
see purple.
I go to the Bay, and they usually have good deals on Levi's.
And you went up to the clerk, and you're like, I'm going to need some maroon
no,
pants.
No, they have a display on it. It's like these corduroy pants.
Oh,
and
wow.
What's sitting there? The maroon ones. I'm fucking right. I always wanted corduroys,
and you?
I always wanted some maroon pants, and I got them.
How much were they?
Did you
$30? They're on sale.
Oh, wow. They look like $30.
100% polyester.
No,
are you
they're
sweating
Levi's,
in them
man.
Right now?
They're Levi's.
How sweaty are you?
Okay, sorry. I'm sponsored by Wrangler.
Can we talk about the socks?
I had to buy my
own. He's got Dunder Mifflin socks.
Yeah, how about those socks?
My Christmas present from Ted.
From Everything Cowboy.
Dunder Mifflin Paper Company
Straight
socks.
Out of Vegas.
Okay.
Yeah, so one side is Michael, and the other side is Jim and Pam.
No, Dwight.
Dwight, yeah.
So, okay, let's move on from me.
Yeah, okay.
Enough of you guys being mean to me.
So our first...
this podcast isn't about you at all. So that's the last we'll talk about.
No, we
got to
break
you.
Down what's happening.
Okay, yeah, go ahead, Wace.
I don't know what's happening. You did this.
Let's go, Papa
Tell the people
Ted.
What happened.
So what we did is we opened up our applications to the world, to the internet.
Man, that...
We had to sort through so many posts, so many messages of people looking
How many came in, Ted? I'm curious.
I cannot confirm or deny how many came in. It's confidential.
It's none of your business. No, okay. Thank you.
One thing we can share is that post...
Yeah, they're all here.
I actually just kept sending in fake ones.
We even got one from Brett Gardner.
Gladys.
We should have got him. I'd have picked him for sure.
Send in a fake Gladys 84 looking to find love.
So, okay, so one thing we can share, though, is that post reached, like, 20,000 people on Facebook, which is insane.
Is that a paid ad?
Photo.
It was not paid at all. It just
all
shares.
Organic.
Yeah, all organic engagement.
There's a lot of hype. Cool. There's a lot of hype on the internet.
A lot of hype.
So they had to submit an application, then there was a screening process.
Yep, screening process. We decided who we were going to invite.
An intense screening process.
Yeah. We had to sort
this
through.
This is like Nexus over here.
It took
yeah.
days to sort through the applications and pick the contestants.
That's because
so.
Ted doesn't read fast. But
And yeah. I'll tell you what, after meeting the girls earlier, Ted did a hell of a job.
Yeah, Papa
we
Ted.
Got some A-listers.
So yeah.
It's the who's who of desperate online daters.
Really quickly, too. Really quickly, too, we should say that Ted's wearing a maroon top. Khaki pants, and we've decided that he looks like a parent for sure.
You're wearing a suit, man.
Tell me I don't look good, I'll take it off.
You look great, but
thank you. Carry on.
He's still wearing a suit.
Always.
Okay, so we're going to talk to each. We're going to have you on the show this time.
Thank God.
Because last time, I don't think we had enough microphones. And so
I already like this.
So it's Dustin.
Better.
It's Dustin, Preston.
There's only one thing missing.
Wacey,
you like this better.
Myself, and we have our contestant on the other side of the table. Our first contestant is Lacey. We're going to give Dustin the info here. He's going to kick us off.
Oh, here's and we got a little
here's a gift. Thank you, Lacey, for coming.
Do you like those, though?
I do.
Guests
you
of
do?
The show. I knew that.
Can you see Wacey across the table?
It's probably better off if she can't see me. Right now. It's probably better off if she can't see me.
We should have had blind dates.
I don't think
sure.
we have. We don't even have blinds, so
okay.
I'm sorry.
Okay. All right, Dustin.
Can you, what about if you move over this way? Will that help you?
Give us some information.
Well, I'll tell you what. I went through the bios yesterday, and there's some great bios.
Yeah.
Also, we try to do some Facebook creeping, knowing the names beforehand, but some of these girls' socials locked up. Yours was not, however.
Not locked. If you want to see it, see it.
Open book.
We were doing some creeping, but there's some real good nuggets in her application. So she said, hey, just looking to apply for a date with that hot piece of Canadian butt, Lacey. Lacey O'Donnell, 27 years young, from the big city of Coaldale. Never heard of it. Favorite Nickelback song would have to be This Afternoon, but here it is. Let's be real. Have they ever made a bad song?
That's a fact.
There's some
and
sparks
honestly,
already.
This
here.
Afternoon is an underrated Nickelback jam. Just going to put that out there.
It's a great
love
one.
That, love that song.
Her favorite color is burgundy.
Oh! The ticks begin.
Favorite food is sushi.
Ooh,
we can dissect that
not
later.
A fish guy.
Yeah. That's not good.
Hey.
Best rom-com, 10 Things I Hate About You.
You know what? That was a really common one, too.
I think there's three
one.
Girls here that all put that, so that's interesting.
Is that one with the one? Heath Ledger? Is he in that one? Okay, cool.
The sad song that you have there, though? Wacey has cried to this,
let's hear
I can guarantee
what
you.
Is it?
Well, the sad song. Well, how about the perfect date, though? She's a comedian. She said April 25th.
Oh.
Really?
She's one of them. Yeah.
She's one.
Not too hot, not too cold.
Oh, wait.
Perfect day for a Calgary Zoo date.
Oh, yeah.
Perfect. Oh, perfect. Oh,
April 25th.
Me
from
Mean Girls.
Yeah. Date. Hey,
you just have to wear a light coat.
She's throwing some zingers in.
I like that.
Favorite hockey team is the Flames. Naturally. She says she had family that played for the Flames. Let's talk about that.
I have a distant relative, yeah. Lanny McDonald.
No, he's from Hannah. Home of Nickelback.
Heard of him.
The 3 degrees of separation of Hannah comes back. All right.
You're ticking a lot of
favorite sport is golf because it's high energy and gets her blood pumping.
I got to talk on that.
Where do you play
what
golf?
What kind of golf do you play?
You're okay with Wacey not being good at golf.
Do you like fight after each hole or what?
Ultimate golf.
Just
golf club.
The scrap.
The number one thing about golf
the scrap on the green after each hole. That really gets
club.
My blood going.
Favorite sad song, A this Thousand one. Years.
Ooh, that's on my sad song playlist.
It's funny because I actually had to Google sad songs.
Nothing on Spotify.
Wait, don't worry. Wacey can show you hundreds.
I have, like, literally. Spilling myself.
And and then her favorite Office character to wrap up the application was Kevin.
I like Kevin.
She relates to him.
Oh, this
job.
Is good.
Feed me. Just smile. Do as little work as possible. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is the lovely Lacey O'Donnell. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
We're excited to have you. So, you know, looking through this, obviously you're 27. I'm not gonna start breaking down age here or anything, but you're 27. What brings you here single at this age? Because you're getting a little...
You are such a piece of work.
Well,
Allie likes you, hey?
Let's talk about it.
I was actually just dropping a friend off at the airport and swinging by, so, you know, why not?
Okay, fair enough.
That's a good answer. Yeah.
That's really dodging the question. But no, we're happy to have you here. What got you most excited about being part of this podcast today?
Probably just the laughs that I got from last year's podcast, listening to that.
So are you an avid listener of the show?
I am.
That's a big plus.
Fan of the show. Love that.
How many of the episodes have you listened to so far?
Teddy will find this out. So answer honestly.
I don't know. More than 15, probably.
That's a good average.
Teddy,
good.
I've only ever listened to one.
So you actually kind of know Wacey already, so you knew what you're getting yourself into.
Yeah, absolutely. That's
what's
why
your,
I came.
What's your first impression? Getting into this, that's what we'd like to know. That
about
like
you, or
yeah, just like
first impression of you.
Yes, of me. Because first impressions
don't
are
don't talk about the lint on his shoulder.
The lint on his shoulder actually ended up in his beard a little bit ago.
Get it out of here.
You know what? You have really nice eyes.
Oh, my yeah. God.
Yeah. That's my nice. Grandma used to say.
Every girl in here just... That's a tick. Are we doing ticks again? Last year we had
that's a nice compliment to receive. That's really nice.
That's a great compliment. Very well, I disagree, but... Just kidding. I'm just here to level you.
All right, so what do you do for a living? What's your career?
I run a Western store in Lethbridge.
Oh. Now, the question is, do you carry any...
Purple pants? For women.
For men, yeah.
Oh, wait, stand up. Are there pockets on the back of those?
I was actually quite excited. We have some very similar to that in women's coming in June.
They fit the same, hey?
Yeah, very, very similar.
Those are good pants.
They're not that tight, man. They're just regular pants. Oh.
Now, we noticed before the podcast started, all the girls, the contestants, have been gathered in the waiting area, the green room, and discussing. What's your thoughts of the competition?
I really don't think there is any.
Oh. Oh.
I mean, they're nice.
Confidence is
but,
killer.
You know.
But you're going to
look at this.
Oh, I love man. The confidence. It is radiating.
So, let's talk about the sushi thing. I'm not a big seafood fish guy.
Okay.
Are you? Is that like a deal breaker for you?
No, like you can just watch me eat.
Good answer.
Okay.
I don't think Wacey's ever been stood up like this.
I think I'm going to ask a question.
Yeah, you go ahead. I'm done.
First date and don't pick zoo lights for the love of God. Just leave that place alone. First date that you're taking, Wacey. Where are you going? What are you doing? Who are you inviting? You have to bring someone.
Like besides Wacey?
Oh,
really?
So I have to take him on a date.
You're taking him somewhere. He's
you're going
to He's not going to ask. You know, he doesn't have the courage to ask a lot of times. So. That's not true, actually. He does all the time.
What the hell, man?
Sorry.
I don't know. Sushi sounds great. And if I'm taking him, then it's going to be cheaper because I'm going to be the only one eating, right?
Oh.
So
savvy.
Some good conversation and a cheap bill. I think that sounds good.
She's good in the pocketbook.
She's smart with her money.
Smart with her money.
Business.
Hope can we see your T4?
Okay, we're going to need your SIN number here real quick.
Lacey, I got a question for you here. Let's go right to it. Let's talk kids' names. Lacey, Wacey, what do you got?
Oh
my gosh. Like, we will not stop having kids so we run out of names.
Stacy.
Oh, there's Casey, Stacy, Tracy.
Macy. Steve.
I mean, and a random, yeah, a random Derek in there.
Julio.
How could you not want that?
Vern.
So, I have a question. If you had to pick a cute nickname for Wacey once you guys start dating, what would you call him? One cute
That's
nickname.
Such
cute
a good nickname. Question.
Wacer?
That's a good one. I get
Wacer
that one.
The Eraser.
Wacer.
I get that one.
Hey, Wacer.
Wacer? That's kind of so nice.
That's one of my hockey
What's
nicknames.
One thing Wacey could do to win you over? What's that little secret thing that he could do?
Probably... eat sushi for me.
Oh.
So
it comes out of this. Will he eat that?
What sets you apart?
I did bring some.
Yeah. just bring your own bag. Just bring your own sushi.
A full fish. Take a bite of that
That's
fish.
Sashimi.
So
there's a trout in her duffel bag.
I can smell it this whole.
What would you say separates yourself from the rest of the contestants? What's your one thing?
I don't know. I'm probably... I want to say I'm funnier, but I don't know them that well yet.
Right, okay.
So I think that I'm just, you know,
I mean,
pretty
confidence is high.
Happy person.
I like that.
Her bio alone, right? Yeah. Do you have any hidden talents? Any talents that would impress Wacey?
I'm actually an avid quilter.
Oh, I like blankets.
Yes.
You can make a blanket and then go under the
I
blanket.
Use a blanket every day.
You can relate to every man.
Amazing.
Quilter.
Yeah, me and my grandmother's quilt every Tuesday.
You hook up with a pioneer woman here.
You can relate to every man.
We all like things quilted.
I do.
Blankets,
I like them, yeah.
All right, warm. So you're a pioneer woman who owns a Western store. And
butter.
Funny enough, she's a comedian whose last name's O'Donnell, like Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh.
So we're really starting to paint the
good
picture.
Good segue.
Lacey, I want to ask you, the Western store, Western Stockman in Lethbridge. Wacey,
do you guys need boots? Ted Selling.
Yeah, well, you need boots. You need silver. You can get it at Western Stockman in Lethbridge. Obviously, Wacey's going to be moving to Lethbridge, so you're going to put him to work at the store or in the trucking company. What's he going to be doing?
Oh, you don't want me driving truck. That's the first thing.
We learned that in the last podcast, that your driving record isn't great.
What?
Well, your mom said that you hit the ditch on your...
driver's license.
Okay, that's one time.
That's embarrassing.
I'm not proud of it, but I still got my license, so frig off.
So, Wacey, is he going to be the greeter at the store, like the... Or is he like the stock boy, or like what's his job?
I think that's a good idea. Like greeter, stock boy. Like he can like, you know, be stocking shelves, but when the door dings, like get up to the front and say hi to someone, just like running back and forth.
Welcome
all day.
To Western Stockman. Can I offer you some pants?
Some purple pants. We'd
burgundy.
Like to show you our ladies section of purple jeans.
Also work for men.
As shown here.
Yeah.
Oh, you guys are comedians, eh?
Oh, this has been a fun first contestant here. Really, yeah, really enjoying this. Is there
Wacey, is there any other questions though? Like, do we need to do the definition for each contestant? Is that something we should do, or maybe it's the winner? Or what do you think?
Let's talk about. So what if I don't want to move to Lethbridge?
Oh,
ooh, that's hard because like I work in Lethbridge. So
are your roots that deep?
We could like meet halfway.
Nanton,
Claire's home. Wacey, I used to play hockey.
I like Nanton better.
Too.
Nanton.
He's an old Palomino.
They have a candy store.
Yeah.
Did you guys know each other at all before today?
No, I've never met him.
You never met?
Had you ever creeped him before?
Yeah, on the Western Stockman page.
Oh. Well done.
Absolutely.
Well done. What do you think of that?
I enjoyed your stories when you were calling Ted Dad a lot.
Does this make a lot of sense?
It's Ted.
It adds up.
It's Ted.
It's Teddy for sure.
It's what you get when you hang out with Don.
Well, we have a real question. You a cowgirl?
Sure. Yeah. Can be.
I'm only a meow boy, so it's fine.
Do you have any closing statements, Lacey? Anything to push you over the edge to maybe get that first impression cactus later on?
Just remember how funny I am and how great I am and how much fun it would be to go on dates with me all the time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I like it.
Wacer.
Mic drop.
All right. We'll cut. Thanks, Lacey, for being on the show.
Lacey.
Thanks for making the trip today.
Hope you enjoy your chocolates.
We'll be back with our...
I will.
First impression cactus is coming in.
Oh.
Not right away, but...
Eddie's over there.
There's still three more.
Eddie's chucking beers around right now.
Oh, yay. I love this song. I heard you singing in the shower. And now you put it on your makeup. I'm still laying in the bed. And I thought I could never stay. I'd feel stuck in one place. Then you came along. And all of that changed. I got these visions keep coming up. Always the groomsman, never the groom.
Take number 40 to get that.
My whoop timing was a little off.
You didn't hear all the bars. Stay away from me,
American woman. Mama, let me be. But in this case, don't stay away from me.
Changing it up this time.
So who do we got?
We're going south of the 49th to America.
Provo, Utah.
That was good, Ted.
That was wonderful.
Teddy's diversifying.
Thank you.
We're going to Utah to Paige Morgan, the 29-year-old, not sure her job yet, but we're going to find that out, whose favorite Nickelback song is Rockstar.
Nice.
And good tune.
Favorite sad song is a little Husband and Wives, a little Cody Johnson.
Ooh, that's a
And
nice
she's
one.
Also really digging Sam Smith. As all of his music is sad songs. not a surprise here. Her favorite color, turquoise, as she's wearing a lot of it.
Oh.
She loves grilled cheese sandwiches. Favorite rom-com, back-to-back, How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days.
It is a good movie.
Her perfect date.
No, it was 10 Things I Hate About You.
Yeah, it's different.
And then How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. That's two different,
they're different
movies.
Just
the 10 that thing. Is two different movies.
Never seen that
but
one.
But both things happening in 10 days.
Plus 10 things in 10 days.
You like zoo lights. They have that in America?
She's never heard of them.
I'm pretty sure on the questionnaire it says must include
lights. Of course it did.
I don't know why I get so much flack for zoo lights.
In that case, well done.
Favorite hockey team, she intentionally left it blank. I mean, she's
not a lot of hockey in Utah.
No.
A little bit, though.
There's it. There's some, like, East Coast. Stuff, wouldn't there be some AHL?
I'm not going to pretend I know about something I don't know. I mean, I'm just there for the fights. Let's be real.
What did you think of the goalie fight last night?
Oh, my gosh. Best thing ever. We were talking about it, and I made the comment that they kind of looked like sumos last night because, like, they had so much gear on, they couldn't do much. But it was really funny.
Yeah, that was a crazy fight.
She will be a Flames fan after today. Her favorite sports rodeo. And her favorite character from The Office is Dwight. How about a big Canadian welcome, Paige Morgan, everybody? Welcome, welcome.
Oh, welcome, hey, welcome, hey, welcome.
Thanks for joining us.
And there was much rejoicing.
First question, Trump, yes or no?
I refuse to talk politics or religion in a public forum.
Yeah. All right, well, we're going to make The Bachelor podcast great again, and we want to know.
Oh, well done.
That was awesome.
First impression of Wacey.
Ooh.
You know, I feel like because we're sitting at the table and the burgundy pants are not showing.
Do a spin.
It's a solid, you know?
My
it's
pants
solid.
Are really getting torched today.
The glasses are working. I think the glasses are working.
They help me see good. That's good.
Help me see good.
You got to rate them on a scale of 1 to 10.
Oh,
go.
Oh, you know, you got to bump those numbers up like a 12.
Ooh.
Ooh. You know that 10's good, right? Yeah.
We're not here for rookie numbers.
She's overachieving. Already a good start.
I am old. I got to work a little harder.
Well, first question I have is this a plot just to get a citizenship in Canada, or are you actually truly looking for love?
Free health care.
Because we could just speed right through this.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, because Eddie is a minister. So someone get this
I'm ordained.
Right,
somebody go on Kijiji and get us a minister right quick.
I'm ordained.
No, he already is. We're good.
You are Eddie?
Eddie is, yeah.
Oh, I'm getting married soon. This is great.
Ordainedminister.com. Best $49.95 I ever spent.
That's probably not
Are you here for the right reasons? People want to know.
Of course I'm here for the right reasons, you know? And when we do get married, I hope you wear that shirt.
When? She said when. Preston, break that down for me.
I think that was a within the year thing that we had right there. I think we're probably going into the next room in 15 minutes or something along those lines. Her parents are actually in a car outside. Yeah.
We've got immigration services outside 4620. Yeah. Say
so
yes. And
saying that, though, so I have a question for you. Are you a live band or DJ person for the wedding?
Live band. Oh, yeah.
Six figure. Gotta get that steel guitar in there.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh.
Ooh.
I like a DJ.
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
He kind of is a DJ sometimes.
Oh,
so
I know.
You might have just
see,
offended
I just
him.
Really,
what kind
this
of
is
band?
What happens. You know? You just...
Do you like those traditional wedding songs like Shout and all that trash out there?
Do How, I like it? No. Oh, do I maybe get on the swish and dance to it? Yes.
On the swish.
That's my new favorite word that
swish.
I picked up here.
In
is
the
that
last
Canadian
day?
Thing?
That's hanging around,
yeah.
That's hanging around Teddy
really?
For sure.
Yeah. Yeah. What's your favorite part about Canada?
Swish.
What do you love about Canada?
Me? Say Wacey Anderson.
Well, it's really clean.
Clean?
Yeah.
That's just our house. That was Storm the other day. That was Storm.
Thank you, Storm. So what do you do? We like to get to know you a little bit here. What do you do for...
You don't have to say what you do for work, just what you do. Like, what do you spend your time on?
What's your deal?
Well,
what's my deal?
Go.
You know, I'm really glad you didn't ask me what I do for work, because I don't have, like, a solid answer, because I do a variety of
Neither
things.
Neither does Wacey.
I was going to say, you fit right in with this group.
Yeah, like, back in the day, Ted had the joke that we're the pajama workforce, you know?
Yep,
like,
just that's right.
Keyboard warriors?
No, I'm not a keyboard warrior.
But, Jenny, I'm pretty good at typing
now. Do you have a set of flannel pajamas?
No, but she does.
Sorry, I do.
They're buffalo plaid, and they're very nice.
Oh.
I seen that you enjoy rodeo. What's been in your involvement with rodeo? Curious.
I college rodeoed at Utah State.
Okay.
I still amateur rodeo a little bit.
Okay.
I met a lot of cool people from it.
Okay. Anything else with rodeo that you're involved in?
Oh, I know what you're getting at right here. Yeah, I am an NFR flag girl.
Oh.
A 5-time NFR flag girl.
Not a big deal.
Not a big deal.
Wow.
Anything else?
What about the Strawberry Days thing?
Accolades.
Were you a
Ted, you're really just throwing me under the bus here right now.
I'm sorry. Have you ever been royalty?
Yes.
Wacey's got another rodeo girlfriend.
I'm going to date myself here a little bit, but I was...
You don't have to say the date. Just say you were...
Please say the date.
Strawberry Days rodeo queen.
What in God's green earth is Strawberry Days?
You don't know what Strawberry Days is.
I mean, it's I'm not big into the rodeo circuit.
Rodeos in the state of Utah.
Oh, wow.
For sure.
I need to go.
Where is it?
It's in Pleasant Grove. They have strawberries and cream. Hence, Strawberry Days.
Nice. Do you want to hear a fun
Pleasant
fact
Grove,
about
this sounds like the setting of a Hallmark movie, doesn't it? We're in Pleasant Grove.
Wait, she has a fun fact about himself he'd like to share.
I was the 2011 Saskatchewan High School Rodeo King.
Oh, I am Rodeo King.
I'm Rodeo Royalty.
Well, this explains a lot.
Where's your tiara?
Lost it.
So you know that
sash. Where is the sash?
You know that you won't be Wacey's first rodeo royalty that he's dated.
Won't be.
Won't be.
Yeah,
no. That's do your homework.
I know from listening to the pod that is a lie.
Yeah, because you're a big fan of the show. Because you, how many of the podcasts have you listened to, Paige?
Actually, all of them.
Whoa. Really? Favorite episode? Whoa. What's your favorite episode?
Yeah.
I'm
Bachelor
sorry.
Season one. Yeah.
Seriously.
That's everybody's answer.
It's really funny. I listen to them when I'm driving.
How's this one going so far?
Well, like I said, it's a literal hot seat right here. Like you're you guys are sun. Kind of grilling me.
We have to, though.
Yeah, we
that's why I set it up this way. All
we're
four of us, nice one of you.
We're just short like a police lamp in the dark.
Yeah, that's what I was just
going
to say. Like, where's...
We know you did it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we need to talk about the elephant in the room.
Go on. Your pants?
No. Aside from my pants.
She probably wore the same ones when she was Strawberry Queen.
Those are right from the Strawberry Factory.
No, so you're from Utah. I'm from Calgary. Mm-hmm. What does that look like?
Ooh.
If this moves forward.
Ooh.
Is he becoming American?
Or are you becoming Canadian?
Mm.
Mm. Mm-hmm. What is your
Or are you just curveballing and going somewhere else?
Yeah, you guys are going to run away to
Africa.
Jamaica.
Your natural place that you would go on holiday.
Wacey, big safari guy.
big safari guy.
Should see a safari pants.
I just want to bless the rains down in Africa. Well,
your pants would just disintegrate out there.
Can we stop talking about my pants?
No, we can't.
Jesus.
Go on.
Well, I don't know. I don't know what it looks like. We're not there yet.
She's got to get the cactus first.
Fair yeah, I need the cactus.
We'll decide after the first impression.
Can you get
cactus.
That across the border?
No.
We're actually going to have to get another one and send it down from a local supplier.
So as a former royalty and NFR fly girl, that's pretty impressive. Any hidden talents? Like what's something that could really wow Wacey?
I can tie a rubber band into a knot with one hand.
Damn.
Good with her hands.
I am shockingly intrigued on how that actually happened.
We need
how
a rubber
are
band.
Figure that out. Yeah.
Can we get a rubber band in here, please?
They're in the drawer, the junk drawer over there.
All right.
Later.
Later she'll do that. Now, have you been to Canada many times?
This is my third trip.
Third trip, okay. So you maybe aren't familiar with all the landscape, but if you could have a perfect first date in Canada with Wacey, where would it be and what would it be?
Well, I think the correct answer to this question, aside from zoo lights, would be hockey game.
Ooh. I love going to the Dome.
Man,
Dome foams for life.
There's no place like Dome.
Have you been to an NHL game before live?
No.
Oh.
All right.
Okay.
Would you watch Wacey play amateur hockey?
I've watched some amateur hockey in my day.
It's not good, is it?
It's,
Hey, you know
unique.
What? I'm pretty good at hockey, so leave me alone.
Wacey's very mediocre at hockey. But he's great at badminton.
A big badminton guy. Actually, not that good at badminton.
He's not.
So Wacey's in a badminton tournament yesterday. Does that impress you? Are you impressed by his accolades and his achievements?
No.
Yeah, that says a lot about hand-eye coordination, you know?
So he wants some more of my accolades and accomplishments.
Yeah,
I've won provincial titles in two different provinces in hockey.
He's also the 2014 CCA bull riding champion.
What
I know that doesn't mean
a
lot south of the border.
Biggest semi-pro association in Canada.
He was the champion.
Not over 70 rodeos a year in five provinces.
I won like $4,000. It was cool.
I think according to the bull stats.
Not my pro bull stats.
I didn't look him up. I just listened.
Do not pull up
episode.
My pro bull stats page.
That'd be rough.
Ooh.
It was rough on the last show for both of us.
We've been asking the contestants if they could give him a cute nickname on the spot here. What's a nickname you'd give Wacey? Just look at that face and then first thing that comes to mind. Go.
I'm going to go with a nickname from my favorite movie, The Sandlot. Squints.
Squints Palidorus.
That is so fitting.
Doesn't Squints make up with that hot chick,
yeah,
though?
He does.
Yeah, that's me.
What I'm saying. Yeah, and she's older.
Yeah.
Go jump in the pool right now.
What's the age gap here?
I'm 20. 29? I turned 28 this year.
Oh, so only.
Oh, you guys are the same age, basically.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, basically. Coming in on 30,
age,
eh?
Age is just
no,
a
no,
number.
29 and holding.
Yeah,
30's coming
works.
Quick. Is that why you're on the podcast? Is that what drove you to it?
Yeah. Desperation, for sure.
Drove you to it.
I am from Utah. I am an old maid there.
I believe it. Okay. Well, we're excited to have you.
Okay.
This is our first international guest.
Here's a gift for you for coming on.
Some Smarties in the shape of a heart. It's funny. Paige and I actually bought those yesterday.
You can only get those in Canada.
You know,
yeah,
Wacey,
I learned that last night, and I said, this is not Smarties.
Wacey,
this is not American Smarties. I don't know what this is.
Your Smarties are rockets.
We did miss one question. What's one thing that you would do to impress other than the rubber band? I just want to know that the thing that will win you completely over, it's not a hidden talent, but the thing that would win Wacey over, what would it be, a sad
like what
song?
What sets you apart from the rest of the contestants?
Please say backflip.
Prove it.
No, backflip, not an option.
Me neither.
Sorry. No splits either.
Me neither.
Really,
I used to be able to do the splits.
Don't have anything.
You should try in those pants.
Like, can someone else answer for me? Can we call a member of the audience?
I don't know, man.
She's phone a friend.
She's run flags in the Thomas and Mack.
Hey. Yeah, which flag do you carry at the NFR?
Have you ever been bucked off?
Oh, this will make Ted's day. Montana Silversmith.
Oh, God. And the start, too.
Opening six.
Yeah, that's a big deal.
I don't know.
Opening six.
What's it like
when the three flags
really fun.
On each side go out?
Have you been bucked off in the Grand Entry before?
Not yet.
Well, you
I feel like it's coming.
But didn't your horse buck off one of the cowboys this last year? Or what happened there?
Mine was one of the ones that when they rode double, it was bucking. And then after the girl got her knee mucked out, then I rode that horse.
Ride the buck out of him.
Would you let Wacey?
No, not the buck.
Had
he
to ride
didn't
the
buck.
Rough out of him.
Would you let Wacey stand in the alley and guide you in? Start? Is that allowed?
She doesn't need that. That's why she's at the NFR.
That's a good point.
I'm pretty handy.
Yeah, she is too, though.
Name three things you're handy at.
When it comes to ranching?
Roping. Just in,
ranching.
Just
roping.
In general.
Roping.
What cowboy shit can you do?
I can do all the cowboy shit.
All of it.
Roping, riding, drinking.
Roping, riding.
In the burgundy pants.
I could 100%. I could go doctor.
Don't let the pants
you ride a horse
you.
In those pants?
Fucking rights I could.
Are they stretchy?
Oh, yeah. They're stretchy as fuck.
What percentage of spandex are they?
What are the chances you will double Wacey in the Grand Entry of the NFR next year?
I'll wear these pants.
Double them in.
I'd love that.
Oh,
in front, though. Wacey's in front with her riding.
Her arms are around me.
Wacey just cuddled up in there.
Okay. Okay. Paige, anything? Any last? Any
closing
words?
Remarks?
Here, closing remarks before we go on to the next round.
No.
Okay.
No, I think I'm good. I think I said everything.
The currency rates are horrible when we go there, but we love having you up here.
Thanks, Paige.
Thank you.
Let's
I'm sexy, come on. you really need me, just reach out and touch me. Come on, honey, tell me so.
That's the best part is the death.
If that doesn't loosen things up, nothing will.
So that Eddie was doing moves you do on a cruise ship.
Oh,
Eddie just looks like
look
he's
like
on
a cruise ship. Director, right?
Yeah, after a couple Long Island,
time
me and Brenda
have
been wild on the B floor.
Gotta get in line soon.
Jazzers. We got beanbags coming up at 2 around the pool.
Jazzercise with Eddie. Here we go.
Jazzercise. I'd pay for that class. I'm not gonna lie, I'd go to that one.
That song was great.
That's a banger.
It's a new one in 2020. That could be a hit.
You know what I think the trends in music are gonna go is like back to the older stuff that none of us have ever heard because it's before our time.
Yeah, like Smash Mouth All Star.
That's a song of our generation.
Yeah,
dude.
Class.
So, oh man, what a day! What a day! We're only halfway through.
What a time to be
it's
alive!
It's already 3:30. We got 23 minutes to kick off. We got to get through these next few shows here. Next few interviews.
And our next contestant is ready.
Yes.
Been chomping at the bit to get on this hot seat. Been ready back there. And you know what? There's got to be an advantage to being the third one out. You kind of get a feel for the competition, get a feel for Wacey. But let's meet her. Nevada Rowe, 27 years old from Black Diamond, Alberta, now residing in Balzac.
Just a bit outside.
Also home of, what's the groundhog there?
Balzac Billy. Billy.
Did he see Shaq? Today is Groundhog Day. What?
Seems a lot like last year.
Did he see a shadow?
I feel like I've been
not completely sure because I have a bajillion gophers, so I'm not really worried about
the one
groundhog.
Okay, did any of your gophers see their shadows?
Have you ever been to the Torrington Gopher Museum?
Oh, I have heard that is an experience and a half.
Have you ever been to the Torrington Bar? It's also amazing.
That's a hot place.
Did you see your shadow today?
Yes,
okay,
of course.
So someone from Balzac seen their
what
shadow.
What in-depth reporting you do?
What does that mean?
Anyways, the Gopher Hole Museum, $2 admission. Maybe that could be
your
first date.
I was totally thinking, yeah.
They got gophers dressed up as little firemen, little cowboys.
Yeah.
They're stuffed gophers.
I'm not sure if this is a dream or a nightmare.
This is real.
All of Thiba.
That's straight nightmare.
All right, let's get to taking a look at her profile. So you sent this in. You sent this in earlier this week.
Mm-hmm.
What made you want to send this in?
My coworker.
Oh.
Because he's a roughie. He does bronc riding and his brother does bull riding. And he sent me the link and I was like, no, they'd never pick me. No, God, no. And then he's like, well, you never know until you try. And I was like, well.
You gotta put your name in the ring.
What are you going to lose?
Shot
come
her
on.
Shot.
Can't win the lottery if you don't buy a ticket.
Shoot or shoot, baby.
Right. Right.
Who is the coworker? Do we know this person?
Yeah, you do. It's okay, though.
Joey Badafuco.
You don't want to tell us?
Lachlan?
Okay.
And his brother Cal. Yeah.
Oh, Cal.
Okay. Cal. Yeah. He did the bronc riding at the New Year's thing. Mm-hmm. He did good. Nice. He's a fan
of the show, I'm sure.
Yeah.
All right. Let's break down this this application. A Nickelback song. She loves them all.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
If you had to choose one, what would it be though?
Animals.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Just acting like we're animals, right? Oh.
Read between the lines.
Do we need to keep going, Wacey? Are you good?
I'm good, bro.
I just got to say, everything that Eddie says has some weird sexual innuendo in it. I'm not sure if it's his tone or just that he looks like
Allie
a pedophile right now.
It's a mustache.
Favorite sad song? The mustache.
Talk about
awesome.
That.
Mustache.
Yeah, talk about it.
It's a beautiful stash.
Great booger.
We don't need him hijacking the show again.
Favorite sad song? The Night by Morgan Wade.
Yeah.
I don't know that one.
I heard it from a girlfriend, and it's very sad, but pump up.
Would you cry together to that one?
Yeah.
Would you hold him?
Yeah, of course not.
Unequivocally, yes.
You'd hold him?
What's that?
You'd hold him? Hold him
make
tight?
Make him feel okay?
Yeah, through the night.
Make him feel safe.
Need to be held.
Okay, your favorite color, turquoise or red? I feel turquoise is popular.
Did you see my truck, though? Clifford, the big red Dodge.
Ooh.
Oh, that's intimidating, Wacey, isn't it? Big red Dodge.
I drive a RAV4.
What color is that? What color is that RAV4?
Purple.
Just like his parents. Favorite food, steak? And whatever else comes with it.
Yeah.
Steak and...
Well, there's like salad or potatoes or whatever else that goes with it. But usually I like my food to eat that, so...
Hey-o.
Ready?
Favorite rom-com, The Ugly Truth.
Ooh. Gerard Butler.
Good movie.
Yeah, he's good in that movie. Yeah,
I could do my laundry.
Who's the girl? Kristen Wiig? Not Kristen Wiig. Who is that?
The blonde girl.
Oh, Katherine Heigl. Yes. Oh yeah, she's good. Yep, she's good.
Perfect date. Go for dinner. Walk off all the food discomforts while staring at pretty lights. Zoo then lights. Grab some snacks.
We're big snack guys.
Big snack guys. Go snuggle and watch
one of the
movies.
Best things that happened to you this year.
Snacks, snuggles, and a movie, Wacey. Is there a perfect date?
I like that.
Those are all Wacey's favorite things. Mm-hmm. Favorite hockey team? It's just a bunch of Flames emojis. I'm assuming a Flames.
Right?
Calgary Flames?
Go yeah.
Flames. Favorite player?
Ooh.
Ooh, he's not there anymore, but Kipper. I really love Kipper.
That's my favorite. He's my favorite. I have two Kipper jerseys.
Wacey, yeah. When he was young, used to put his pads on in the dome and stand on the stairs and replicate.
Mm. Yeah, you must have read Wacey's MySpace.
Kipper's kid.
He knew that already.
My MySpace.
This is an interesting one. Favorite sport, rugby.
Rugby. Yes.
Please roll your R's rugby. Moving forward.
I can't rugby. I can't do that.
Rugby.
You can't? Give it a go.
Rugby.
If that doesn't turn these ladies on, nothing
That's
will.
That's terrifying.
So rugby with the is it rugby Mexican sport? Is that where you rolled your R?
Oh my God.
Not Mexico.
Do you live under a rock secretly somewhere?
You're a sports guy, dude.
So why are you a rugby
fan? He lives on a cruise ship.
I actually used to play rugby in high school. Back when it was a mixed team, and then they were like, that's not allowed, and blah, blah, blah. And so then I just love the sport.
Can you take Wacey in a fight?
I don't know. I don't really like to fight guys.
I've never been in a fight.
Does that make sense? I don't like to fight.
So she likes rugby. Yeah. So you're kind of a rough and tough kind of girl, is that right?
I guess.
All right.
You take part in the fight golfing too, wouldn't you?
Yeah, make it a contact sport. It makes everything better if it's a contact sport.
Last thing on the bio is the favorite character from The Office, which Wacey's a big fan of. Your spirit animal is with Jim.
Jim, because he's a prankster, and I am like a huge prankster.
What's the best prank you've ever pulled?
Ooh, okay, so I went on this trip to Ecuador in high school, and the poor fella... The bunk beds we were living on, he was in the next whatever screened area next to us, and the bunk bed have boards in it, and I had to take the boards out, so the bed just sat on the frame, and this fella came running back and jumped on the bed, and it dropped about 6 feet onto the next guy, so it was in for the win, I tell you.
It sounds like a scene from Step Brothers.
That's really good. Did you own up that it was you, or just like, whoa, hey?
Oh, they knew. They knew.
Right. Have you already pranked Wacey and he doesn't know yet?
No.
I fall easily for pranks. Mm.
Falls easily for
oh, no.
And pranks.
Don't give me that.
All right, so I've been just on your Facebook here. Is this the red truck?
Yeah, that's my Clifford.
Okay,
yeah.
Nice. Is that you?
Yeah, that's me.
Let's take a look at this photo evidence. She is a bronc rider.
Jeez. Ranch bronc rider, yeah.
Here we go. So in my investigating, I see you're riding here. It looks like you're out in Winfield. Is that Winfield?
Yeah, that's Winfield. Winfield, right. Alberta, yeah.
I see we'll Winfield Feed Farm banner in the background. Shout out.
Dustin Edwards, P.I.
How good is this guy at Facebook, like, honestly?
All you need is a set of aviators and you look like a private investigator.
So mutual friend Wacey Anderson, had you guys met before?
No, I don't. I'm pretty sure we haven't. No. It was just kind of like through mutual friends. Mm-hmm. And I listened to the podcast. And
she was like, yeah.
Let's talk about your bronc ride.
Yeah.
So, you know, Wacey, a 2014 CCA champion.
Not a big deal.
Holds provincial titles in two provinces, as you've heard.
Heck yeah.
And a national championship and a couple of league titles. Not a big deal either.
But that's in hockey, so.
Ride off.
And he's humble, so it's nice.
Would you take her in a bronc match?
Not a chance.
No, not a chance.
What's your high score?
I got off on the pickup, man. That was cool.
I'm not going to go there.
Ooh, title of my sex tape.
Your sex.
Woo! Get out of here. Shut the front door.
That's funny.
I don't know.
When it comes to like bronc riding, like I was I'm terrified of horses that are supposed to buck. But if it's like a saddle horse that like it surprises you in a buck, that's cool. I like that. But like a horse that's meant to buck, that's dumb.
I don't know where this is going. What made you want to ride bronc? Let's talk about your past a little bit here. What's your story?
My past. We're getting deep now.
Yeah, what's your story?
My story. What's I like ranch rodeo, and I got into the ranch bronc riding. You can thank Pearly Whirly for that. She's gone to the States and the Texas bronc riders a deal, and it's phenomenal. And she kind of got me into it, but I kind of like my face, and I can't work if I get hurt or stepped on or something like that, so.
Are you a model or what?
No. Should I be? Do you think I should?
Come well, on. I'm just, you said you can't work if your face is hurt.
Well, yeah, because, I don't know, I like it.
Fair enough.
Mm-hmm. Don't want to get stepped on. Don't want to get hurt. Don't get paid if you get hurt.
So you're are you retired or are you still going?
I do it from, I'm sure, this year. I'm going to possibly do that. Don't tell my parents that. Yeah.
They're going to listen and you're in trouble.
Ah, shit.
Oh, and swearing.
Wacey's going to be heading to Winfield. Can you help you on?
No.
Pull your rope.
Take that any way you want to.
No, I'm kind of retired from it. Do it from the odd time.
Do up your back cinch.
All right, so we never asked the question of your first impression of Wacey. Obviously, you were friends on Facebook.
Yeah.
And you applied, and knowing it's Wacey, but what's your first thoughts of him?
Ooh, the flow is strong.
The flow is strong with this one.
Yeah, the flow is strong. I don't know. It's one of those things that it's like you've known a person, but you don't really know them, and you kind of want to know them. I don't know.
It's kind of like Tinder.
Would you swipe on Wacey?
Ooh. Yeah, I guess I would. I'd be like, why not? I don't have
like
Tinder,
but... Isn't there like a super like or something now?
Yeah, there's a super like.
Would you super like? Does that cost money?
Yeah, it does. It costs money, but I'd do it. Come on, let's go for it.
Oh,
good. Hey. What are your thoughts of the other competitors?
They are lovely women. They are lovely women, and they all deserve a good chance at the waist.
Wacey's got a tough decision coming up.
Right? This is tricky, you know.
So your perfect first date... You talked about this movies and snacks. Is that legit? Or where would you take Wacey if you had to show him a good time?
Show him a good time? Oh, the McDonald's play place. Because I think we'd still be tall enough for the ride, you know? Just kidding. Probably, like you said, we had to include zoo lights. So, I mean, you have to do that. But, I don't know, food. Who doesn't love food? And then hanging out and just talking. And you usually put on a movie and then you talk through it anyways. And you're like, oh, I've never seen this movie. Oh, it's great.
Kind of movie.
What kind of movie?
Would you do like rom-com action? What kind of thing would be the first one?
I have to thank my sister for getting me into the rom-coms.
Like Hallmark stuff?
Yeah, the Hallmark. Nicholas Sparks.
Huge. Preston's
weeping,
back.
No. Crying.
Huge Hallmark guy. He loves them.
Yeah. Can't get enough of those absolutely atrocious movies. Yeah.
They're great films.
You really like them.
They're good.
Yeah.
They're so cheesy. They're I'm so sorry. Predictable. But you can laugh at it and you're like, oh, that's great. Mm.
So what's been your worst date you've ever been on?
Oh,
that's a hard one. I actually had a guy walk out on me once and left me with the bill.
Pray tell.
It was this really lovely person that I met through the Tinder. And this is where I actually gave up on Tinder, guys, just so you know, fun fact. But he left me with the bill because he was a cheap ass. So, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Wacey would never leave you at the bill. He would split with you.
He'd bring a bag of sandwiches for you. This is a fancy restaurant. Yeah, look at my bag of sandwiches.
Do you like bologna or ham?
No cheese.
Couldn't afford the cheese. I got shredded cheese.
Say when.
So 27? That's your age, correct? 27?
Yes, sir.
All right, so you're on the lower end of our age scale, or where are we at? We're kind of mid-range.
Let's not talk about
it. You care a lot about these numbers.
The numbers are big.
Why?
I don't think you're supposed to be sharing those numbers.
Oh, well, they're on the bio.
FOIP?
Getting FOIP.
Are we going to get sued again? Last year we got sued on the podcast.
I mean.
Really?
Yeah. Yes.
That's rough.
Luckily we have a few lawyers that listen, so they were willing to help us out. Yeah. We have some legal advice on...
We're not dropping names anymore.
Legal? That's all you need to know, right?
Yes. Yeah. So we're not getting sued. You know, Wacey's he's eyeing the future life. You know, are you looking for kids, marriage, or what's your plan?
I want to have enough kids to create our own hockey team so that you win all the time. Right?
That's like 23 the roster spots. That's
quite a few. Yeah. 23 children.
Get the hut van out. I get a question, actually. So last year it kind of got, and knowing Wacey well, his mom is a big deal in his life. And what would be the first thing that you would do to win his mother over, because she really
Tough
wants
sell.
Him to be happy, and she really wants him to bring women home early. And you know what? I can't disagree with her, because to this date it hasn't worked the other way, so this could be the deciding factor. So what would you do to win over his mom?
Oh.
Well, first message to Paula is I can back up a trailer.
Ooh.
I can use my mirrors. And I don't know. I love all things bovine and horses. And your mom's right. Don't pick up chicks from the bar. That never works. That never works.
You've never seen this guy dance before. Not then.
Oh, my goodness.
It's good.
I literally watched Wacey dance around a beer bottle.
I watched him and John grab each other's legs last night and spin in a circle at the bar.
I dance. Great dance. I'm good at dancing.
All right. Well, we have any other questions for the Bronco?
Ted, do you have anything?
I'm good. I got nothing. You guys have got it all.
Great job. Can't wait to see you crack out next year. What are you watching? On the Bronx.
Oh, the Bronx. I thought there was like the Bachelor 3, and I'm like, oh. I don't know.
you'll be in contention. I believe it. No, for this one. Not for next year. This year. Take your Lindors.
I can see you got your ride on this old cowboy. And I can tell you never had one for your own. Oh, you never been around one. Now you're thinking that you found one. Well, it might be kind of fun to take him home.
You giggle every time that I say yes, ma'am. And I get this feeling if I held you tight. You'd be seeing his and hers, buckles, boots, and spurs. But that feeling you'll get overnight.
Cause what you gonna do with a cowboy when that old rooster crows at dawn? Lying there instead, getting out of bed and putting on his boots and getting gone.
You gotta put Kiss by Prince on. Damn.
You dance, titty, dance.
Whoa.
Not quite the dance track we had last time, but...
That was a...
Figured I'd just change it
was
up.
Is that an actual Prince song? Or a remix? Is that a remix?
It says it is.
Damn.
I don't know.
If it says it on the internet, it's true.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah. So.
Internet owes everything. All right.
Here we go.
All right, we're down to our fourth and final contestant of The Bachelor 2.
Fourth and final contestant on The Price is Right.
We're going to Callie Godkin, who is the 19-year-old, almost 20-year-old. Really hung up on the age. But
you gotta include it there.
She says she's 13 going on 30, folks. Mm.
But you said earlier, age is just a number.
Age is just a number.
But let's read into this some more. She says age is just a number because let's be real. All trophy wives are younger.
Ooh. Hey.
It's true.
Okay.
Valid point.
Valid point. She's from Red Deer County. Mm-hmm. So... Is there, not a town, just you're from the Red Deer County?
No, I'm from, just outside of Innisfil, but I reside in Red Deer for work and university.
Mm-hmm. Okay, interesting. Oh, schoolgirl, you guys are both in school. Mm-hmm. Favorite Nickelback song? It's a toss-up here between Rockstar and Burn It to the Ground.
Ooh.
All right, two good choices. Wacey's liking that. Favorite sad song would be Michigan for the Winter by Ryan Hurd.
Heard that.
Her favorite color is blue. She enjoys for her favorite meal a good steak or a bison burger.
Oh, that's a little off the board. I like that.
Yeah.
A bison burger.
Yeah, because my parents, we own a bison and cattle ranch. So, you got to put that down.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you bring any?
No. Maybe next time. I was thinking for next time.
Guy on a buffalo.
Ted, you probably got some pot stickers that'll be just as good.
Favorite romantic movie, How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. That's the second one we've heard
of. It's a classic,
right?
Though.
Is Matthew McConaughey in that one?
Yeah.
I've never seen it.
They love him.
You'd like it.
Yeah,
it's good.
I'm more of a rom guy. Ditch the calm, straight rom.
This is shattering.
Let's keep going through the bio here. Her favorite, her idea of a good date is the Calgary Zoo lights. Wow, there's a shocker. But it can't be minus 40, so you're a fair weather woman? Is that what you'd like to say?
Digging that minus 40. If you want to go when it's minus 10, for sure, haven't been.
That's
love
the threshold.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Favorite hockey team? She loves the Calgary Flames because Johnny Gaudreau and Matthew Tkachuk, two babes.
How could you pass them up? It's who's hotter? Let's coin toss.
Only thing I could knock on Tkachuk is his haircut. It's not great.
I don't like the sides, but you have nice hair, so it works.
Thank you.
She also is a fan of rodeo, another favorite sport. She loves a good Calgary Stampede. And, you know, Wacey used to, or he's the shoot opener at the Calgary Stampede.
Woo.
Yeah. You can see him down there.
And drinks a lot of drinks at the Calgary Stampede.
I didn't even go out one night this year at Stampede.
He probably gets more TV time than anyone.
That's true.
Stampede.
Yeah. Ted used to do that job, and then he got a blister.
Hey, I want to wreck my keyboard hands, boys.
And her favorite Office character, Jim Halpert. She's a big Jim fan.
I like Jim just because he does everything and he tries to do it like as small as possible to get the outcome. Mm-hmm. Like, he's just there. He's just like whatever he can do to get done.
Mm-hmm. All right, so there it is. There's Callie. Welcome to the show, Callie.
Yes, thank you.
Happy to have you, our final contestant. Is there any advantage to going last once you've heard all the nonsense from these other three
contestants?
Honestly,
I think no. I just think like it's good. Like, I'd rather go. I'd go any number, first, last.
Okay, speaking of number, you're the youngest here. You got. Some of these girls got 10 years on you. That's
a
decade.
Age is a number. Let's be real. They can have kids. Anyway, no.
I'm a numbers guy.
Moving on from Dustin, your first impression of Wacey. Comment on the hair.
Not or the hair. Age. I've seen his socks. I was like, where do you get those socks? Like, those are nice socks.
My dad.
Papa Ted.
Had to be. They're nice.
Teddy will buy you a pair of socks for
your
wedding present.
Can we get matching socks?
Mm-hmm. I'm into that.
Okay.
All right, so Callie, who are you? Tell us who you are. We want to go
in three words.
What do you want to know? Three words.
No.
You're in university. What are you taking?
I'm working towards my bachelor degree, like in business. I'm working for an oil field company right now, so I do management and computer programming.
You
and
guys
I do user
business.
Manuals wow. for the rigs. Business. Yeah.
Strategy. Wacey also does
black leather gloves.
Sustainability.
Yeah.
Prestige.
Blisters.
Synergy. Investors, possibly you.
All right, Callie, so I was doing a little research on your social media.
Oh, no.
What do you do for fun, Dustin?
Well, I mean, like, I had a pretty good story on yesterday. I was going to put, like part one, part two, part three, but I was like, I don't want to get out there.
This is where I'm going. Yesterday, I got a little notification. She's wedding dress shopping.
Oh.
And tags
yeah,
the
I went
show.
To Edmonton.
Tags the show with The Bachelor, and you had a shot of a wedding dress. So
you buy anything?
Is that confidence?
No,
what?
Put a deposit down.
That
so
is confidence.
I was gonna try some on, but then I was like, you know what? I don't want to ruin it. So honestly, I'm just gonna pick one. And I was like, just because it's Super Bowl Sunday and everything, I was like, will you guys hold it till Monday? Because like, I'll know by then. I like narrowed it down to three.
Put a $1,000 deposit down on that.
Yeah. Tell you what, this chick's got confidence.
Would you marry Wace if he had a full tuxedo in that pant? Suit.
I really like the casual look. It's very boho. Oh. It's nice. It's not like too like you're a little dressed up, but like
I'm always dressed up.
I was like, oh, who's the bachelor? Because I don't know Wacey. So it's like, oh, which one?
No,
jokes.
Then you see the father and the cruise ship captain. And yeah. Pretty easy to figure
out. This is quite the mixed bag that we're sitting here.
So you found your wedding dress. So there's one step.
Yeah.
You're just a rose away from.
I drove all the way down
thing.
Here. You know, I troubled those roads. Like
Teddy got your fuel.
I watched everybody like hit the ditch, and I was like, I gotta get there. I can't be late. I gotta be here. Just can't.
I was late.
Yeah. He's hung the fuck over. Is what
I
he
actually
is.
Feel pretty good. I feel good. I'm good.
How are you feeling this
Three
morning?
Three Bud Lights in, eh?
Your Instagram. You got like over how many thousands of followers? You got?
I got a few. You know,
10,000.
Maybe.
Or 12,000.
Maybe give or take. So you know, maybe after today I'll have more.
Not
she's
a bad
got
over 10,
so she's got some social reach.
Yeah, I used to do modeling. You met me when I like did
that's
some
right.
modeling.
Yeah,
you
that's
were like
we
MC'ing
met.
Back in the day.
Yeah, we met at an event.
You MC'd at modeling?
Yeah, I MC'd
Yeah, and he did a really
event.
Good job. It was like 10 out of 10.
I don't doubt
recommend.
That. 1 minute. Yeah.
Thank
this
you
needs
for the
to be at least... Three times this size.
Actually, funny story. The girls were modeling, and I lost the script of their outfits, so I just shot from the hip for the last 10
it was
girls.
Good.
Yeah, it was pretty fun. Anyways, it's not about
fun
me.
Fun fact:
today.
I'm a.
Model. This isn't about you.
Yeah,
no,
I'm a model.
So
yeah, Wacey is a model.
I'm a model.
Too. Does the modeling thing weigh in for you that Wacey's a model, or do you?
I've been in 3 photo shoots.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Then we can take like really good Instagram pictures together. Oh. We can get some wife's wedding ones.
Damn.
I'd even let you wear the pants. We could color coordinate.
I might wear a white tux.
This is a power couple. So if you, if you add up your 12,000 followers and Wacey's 277, you guys are the Instagram power couple.
We'd just be a power couple in general.
I
don't have to be
2,000,
Instagram.
Not a big deal.
What kind of cute nickname would you give Wace?
Wace.
Ooh, I like that one. I get that lots.
Wace?
Wace.
I was waiting for someone
hey,
to call
Waze,
me.
Hey, come here.
You like, say, you say waste or waste?
No, waste. Like, not waste.
Someone to call me like
I
Huggy
get
Bear
he's
wasting.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
Huggy Bear.
Snookums would have been a good one, too.
Snookums.
Yeah. What would you call him? You guys have recently gone over your deep friendship.
Yeah, Snookums. Yeah.
That's what you do call him. Saved in the phone.
Lemony Snickets.
Yeah, that's my alter ego.
So anyways, let's go back to your life.
My life.
What's your plan in the next 2, 3, 4 years?
Well, I'll be
done. Doesn't involve Wacey.
That doesn't involve Wacey. Well, I'll be done school. And yeah, I'm just like working right now. So it's hard to find love out there, like not on Tinder and that, when all you do is work in university.
She's like, you're goal oriented.
Do you relate to that, Wace?
Because like, who goes to the bar in Red Deer? Let's be real.
Well, ever since they changed the name of Billy Bob's
to
Stupid Long Riders. It's not the same. Well,
I'll still call it Billy Bob's, though.
Yeah, you're like, hey, Billy Bob's. Everybody's like, what's Billy Bob's?
Would you take Wacey dancing at Billy Bob's, though?
Of course.
Would you buy him
you
a
Koobie go?
After?
Duh.
A what?
She's a winner. Koobie saw. You never had a Koobie saw?
Oh, like the hot dog stand.
Yeah, with the bacon and the cheese and everything else.
Funny story. The dog father used to be set up outside our ranchman's. Dog father. And he used to have like little like things of cereal.
Oh, those are delicious.
One night I stood outside of the dog father stand and I ate the whole tub of Captain Crunch.
That a high point?
Speaking of,
I'm impressed.
Speaking of that, yeah. Callie, do you have any hidden talents that
you
want to
share
with us?
Honestly, no.
What separates you from these women that
age.
Are tenured?
I'm going to be honest. We're it's a number, but like when you got your life on the go, you got your life on the go.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Are you worried that Wacey won't be able to keep up in his old age?
No, because that's why they have like, you see like Anna Nicole Smith and all them with their wheelchairs. I'll be like, handicap parking, guys. He's old.
She's passed on now.
That's funny.
Oh, that's great. So Hef and his future girl here. Ideal first date with Wacey, where would you like him to take you?
I haven't been to the Calgary Zoo yet, so I mean, I would take that. Mm-hmm.
You get a photo with Santa, too.
Yeah.
I know him.
We could do the penguin walk. That looks
like
fun.
Yeah.
I've
penguinos.
Never did it. I really want to do it, but big it's like, man. I don't want to go alone, you know?
Mm. All right. Well, I don't know. I think you're a good candidate here. She's, you know, spry and business-minded.
Oh, yeah.
And
you know it.
All right, Wacey, any questions? Closing questions?
I'm good.
Spry.
He's so hungover. I don't know what spry means. It sounded good.
That's good.
Do you have any questions, Dustin? Because you said you're lurking Instagram.
I got them all out there.
Okay.
I just said the wedding dress was...
I was going to do like a series though, like part one. And
that's
like,
funny. Yeah.
But I didn't want to take it out there.
I wish you would have brought the
Costco
dress.
Because Costco had roses too.
Sorry, where would you have this wedding though?
Where would I have this wedding? Mm-hmm. Wherever you
please say
like.
Ted's house.
Oh,
I like your backyard,
in an
Ted.
Hour.
In an hour. Yeah.
But how bold would a bachelor be showing up here wearing a wedding dress?
I would have been just
that would have been next
impressed.
Level.
Well, like my favorite one didn't quite fit right in alterations just on Super Bowl Sunday. It wasn't possible.
Sorry. I gotta go. If we do Bachelor 3, can you propose to the person at the end?
Oh, yeah. And I walked by a jewelry store and I was going to look at rings, but then I was like, I better not push it.
Yeah.
Because I got to get there tomorrow.
Hope you like ring pops.
I do. I was thinking blue.
This is the little plastic thing.
I ate it.
Well, you're the first contestant to dress shop the night before the show. So congratulations. Mm-hmm.
I was prepared. Thank you.
Very good.
Thanks, mm-hmm. Callie. Right.
Thanks
for
coming on.
Thank
you.
I'm just going to let this play underneath while we're talking for a while.
God,
that's a great song.
Let it play forever.
The sax. Okay.
Fine. I love hot sax. You get me going. I'll get...
That's what she said. That,
that was one thing we were missing in the show was
some
the sax.
Some hot sax.
How about that cactus that first...
All right. So,
we have a real one we can actually give away this year. We got it yesterday at the garden store.
So the ladies are gathered in the living room area.
Yeah, the green room. The green room.
Just are we bringing them all, or are we just gonna call them the first?
I guess we should probably bring them all in.
I think we should just call the one in. And
no, bring them all
see
in.
The
they can, well, hear
bring
us.
All
they
in.
Can
see
hear
the,
us.
But yeah. I want to see the reaction.
Okay.
Don't you guys?
So they're
see?
Just right now. We'll just give our fans a
bring
visual. They're
in.
Just coming by the Buffalo.
Nevada, Paige,
guy in a Buffalo.
Kelly. And Lacey with the puppy. Oh,
she's brought the puppy.
The puppy.
It's a tactic.
That's a cheat.
You can't not pick her now.
All right. Well, so first off, I want to thank everybody for coming out.
It was good. It was very nice. It's not easy to do to come on a podcast and get like grilled by four dudes. Pedal my sex tape. So first impression Cactus. There was a lot. There was some like they're all overall really good first impressions.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about how you feel, Wace, right now.
I feel great.
Yeah, how you doing?
I'm doing well.
Are you excited? Like, do you think you're gonna actually find love today?
Maybe. Anything's possible, right? Never say never, as our friend Justin Bieber says.
You're just going to put him in your car and take him right to your mom?
Yeah. Yeah, the date's happening tonight.
Right now.
Yeah.
What is the first date? Don't know.
I don't know, man.
Last year, Ted gave that $12 gift card.
I don't think there was anything on the gift card.
You know what? I never even got the gift card last year. So
classic.
What are we putting out this year?
It's in the mail. Well, we've actually got some tickets to Mamma Mia on Thursday.
Mamma Mia.
Oh, are you serious?
I've never seen Mamma Mia. I love ABBA.
You get to go with Storm and I and my mom.
Is that the date?
That's the date, yeah.
So Ted's mom's a saint.
So basically, your mom won the Bachelor?
No, my mom has the tickets, and she says we have space to bring more people. So if you want to like bring your date, then here you go.
And your mom.
I've never seen Mamma Mia, and I love ABBA, so...
You don't have to sit at the same table as my mom. Like, my mom will be there, like mom. Different table. You can see her around
the
show.
I'm not the kind of guy you bring home to your mom.
But maybe mom? My mom. So that's what's on the line. Mamma Mia on Thursday. Paige leaves Wednesday.
Thursday. Okay. All right. So... Here, so my first impression Cactus goes
to... I'm nervous. Can we do a drum roll?
Drum roll.
Yeah, drum roll. Lacey.
Oh, Lacey.
First impression.
Nice fit, Teddy.
If this song doesn't rev you up, you're just, not human.
I'm just going sidelines here for a second, guys.
Yeah.
We're just sitting down to our sideline reporter, Justin Edwards.
Hey, guys, I'm down here on the sidelines with Lacey after the first impression. Tell us about how you're feeling right now.
I am on cloud nine right now.
But you realize...
Is that the puppy or Wacey?
You realize that the Cactus winner... Does the Cactus winner... Are they eligible for the rose?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Definitely, yeah.
So you're still on... Do you have the upper hand here?
I know. I told you that at the beginning.
Holding this dog, is this a tactic?
Yes.
I like...
Back to you guys. Back to you, Jim.
Thanks, Justin.
We went really hard-hitting journalism right there.
Ollie Williams on the weather report.
It's raining. It's raining sideways.
You want this dog?
Okay, wait. So why did you give her the... Let's talk about why you gave the dog. What was the first impression?
I did this. Like, she was funny. She really played into her... Like, she was backed up her application. Like, she knew what she was talking about. She wasn't just saying that she liked a Nickelback song or, like, she... Oh, I'm forgetting.
You're a word.
You really left an impression.
No, she was
Cousins with Lanny McDonald. No, had been a winner too.
Yeah, and love Lanny. He's a national. He's a Calgary.
Yeah,
treasure.
I thought that was definitely gonna be good. A sealer for you.
Yeah. Well, it's just like she backed up her shit.
Mm.
She has her shit together.
Mm. What else? What else?
She
about
has
shit
a real job. It's a good thing.
Wacey's working at the Western.
Wacey just needs a job right now.
Yeah. So that's it. Just boils down to me.
Let's talk about this stock greeting job a little bit.
That cactus.
I feel like I would excel
till.
At that.
I think I
view myself as a people person, and greeting people walking into a store is like right up my alley.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, congratulations, Lacey, your first impression cactus recipient.
Yay!
Put that song back on.
Hold on. I'll get back to it.
So we're gonna kick.
We're gonna bring in Allie.
Gonna bring in Allie for some first half analytics.
Yeah.
Before we. Finish up the show. Here we go.
I can see what's happening.
What?
And they don't have a clue.
Who?
They'll fall in love, and here's the bottom line. Our trio's down to two.
Oh.
The sweet caress of twilight. There's magic everywhere. And with all this romantic atmosphere, disaster's in the air. Can you feel the love tonight?
Come on.
The peace the evening brings.
All right.
Okay, before you do that, though, disaster is most definitely in here.
That's not the underlying theme of this whole show.
Oh, that song segues really good into what I wanted to talk about, which I've been saving for this moment, actually, that love is in the air.
There it is.
It's
you two at the table.
There it is.
Side note about that. Sorry. The first picture Dustin and I put on Instagram, I get an inbox notification from Preston. He's like, huh, love really was in the air.
Factual statement right
that
there.
That is outstanding. Man, I missed that all day today. I'm kind of sad that I didn't hear it more.
But you know what, though? Last year, you threw it around a little bit carelessly.
You were reckless. You were really reckless.
I threw love recklessly around
you
last
did.
Year.
And this year, you've really dialed it in.
Well, I think it really comes back to how Wacey's a little bit more guarded now. Maybe he's not throwing love out that hard.
Oh,
he's not willing to cry.
It's got
to
be earned.
So.
Do you want to know something, though? I've never told a girl I love them.
Ever in your life?
Really?
One time.
You want to start today?
Good. Anything's possible.
Start with Allie.
I love you.
I love you. I love you. So how much different would things be if Allie won last year?
Oh.
Holy
throw that in there. Just like, what would have happened, Wace? Like,
I wonder if I'd be the, Dustin, I'd be the Bachelor.
Would you still be wearing that shirt?
No, I'd probably be in the Bachelor.
So looking at it, I would be posting on Instagram and Facebook, social media like weekly.
Riding horses and
daily.
Whatnot.
I'll be riding horses.
Yeah,
I would
roping.
I'd be probably running the Drumheller Drive.
As the non rodeo guy, I've never been more confused about what you guys do.
I'm living my best life.
Now I know.
With my girl by my side.
That's all he's doing.
Love is in the air.
So you're welcome. By the way,
thank you guys.
You're welcome. I did thank Ted. I personally Snapchat messaged you and thanked you for inviting me. I was hesitant.
I'm glad you were here, Allie.
Me too.
I'm glad you found love.
All right, Allie, we brought you back for some analysis.
All right.
Some knee-jerk reactions. What do you have to say?
Well, I got a lot to say. No, I don't.
That's easy.
Pulls out a scroll. Whips out a scroll.
Can't stop talking.
Rolling it up.
No, I do want to say, as like a whole of the women that are here, that I actually feel like there's some genuine, like they're all genuine. I think there are actually some good options. Mm-hmm. I think they're here for the right reasons.
You didn't feel that last year and you were part of it?
I mean,
she knew she didn't like Wacey that much. She was just there for the ratings.
Let's get some honesty on the table here.
I was followers. Here for the football game, obviously.
Yeah, she's here for the Super Bowl.
But no, I just think that there's actually these girls want to be here for you, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, they actually applied to be here. They signed up for this. It wasn't just me begging people to come.
That's crazy.
And I mean, they all have great hair. You like hair. You like good hair. They got good hair.
You like hair?
Yeah. He's got a couple balls of a bag downstairs. Yeah,
you've been in his freezer, haven't you?
Big hair.
But I'm just saying, looking in the future, your kids would have great hair was kind of what I was getting at. Mm-hmm. But anyways.
Stacy, Casey.
Wacey. Tracy.
And Tracy.
Macy. And
Macy.
But you obviously gave Lacey the first impression cactus, mm-hmm. which was a great choice. I think she had a lot of good things to say. She was funny. She was attentive to your questioning. Mm-hmm. So that was good. Paige, she's wearing really, really cute pants today. Mm-hmm. She's got some good style.
Better than yours.
And I think she was a great option too.
America.
The fact that she lives far away is a little bit, that sucks. But
not if she becomes a citizen.
Ooh. That's true. Car, if you baby. Lock her down. There's opportunity
and
for that.
And she can't really get away from you.
I've got a ring guy.
See?
You got a guy?
Thanks maybe to you're Montana the ticket. Service, Ms. Proud sponsor. Yeah. Cowboy Shoes.
We're going to step away for a quick commercial here.
And Nevada, I think that she'd be like a fun chick to. She probably would want to do lots of the stuff you want to do. Mm-hmm. Right? She's like
do
a good
some
guy's girl.
With you.
Yeah.
Ride around her big red truck.
Exactly. She could pull you when you get stuck.
Are you embarrassed that she has a bigger vehicle than you?
No, I love my RAV. It's sick.
Dude. Size doesn't matter, Ted.
Check my fuel economy, then talk to me.
That's what gets said in your relationship.
Buddy, when I put that thing in eco mode, I save on fuel like no other.
It's a carbon footprint. Wacey's a real
when
hero.
He puts it in eco mode, I can just hear all the women screeching.
But,
they're so excited and covered.
But when I drop her into sport mode, let me tell you.
Woo.
I'll be doing some Fast and Furious Tokyo drifting.
And then Callie was the last girl to go.
And I think that she'd be a good option for you because she seems super fun and bubbly. And I think she'd be someone who'd like to go do lots of, like, she'd probably go to Zoo Lights every year with you.
She'd do
like
bubbly things.
I like the bubbly.
Spry.
She's very spry.
She's spry. She's still got spots.
But I think it's going to be a hard choice for you.
Yeah.
I mean, I would look into the distance thing. That's an important factor at this day and age. And
you mean like driving or his future?
No, like driving.
No.
Well, I don't know. I'm a little, maybe I'm just needy, but I want to be within a easy driving distance of
Dustin,
the person
is she
I
needy?
Love.
How long did it take for you guys to move in together? That's what I want to know.
What's that?
When did you guys move in together?
Yeah, how well
officially
did the bachelor
or?
Work?
Second date, she left some stuff in my house.
No, I didn't.
She's lying.
I swear, I didn't actually. I wasn't going to pull out any of those moves.
Moving on.
What's their emotions in there now? You've sat in that room waiting to hear the rose
the
ceremony.
What's
are
the
they
vibe like?
Are they nervous? Are they
Pins
ready?
And needles.
They look pretty nervous. Very nervous. They're on their phones. Oh, one's sweating.
They're waiting for Teddy's pot stickers to come in.
I'm kind of sweaty.
Someone's I think they're, but I actually think that they're excited for this opportunity. Mm-hmm.
This is a big moment.
Mm-hmm. I'm excited about this.
Do you think
this.
There's anyone that's going to take rejection negatively? In that room.
Is there anyone going to flip this table over?
Is There's Storm going to have to escort side. Someone
If someone's going to flip it over, it's Nevada because we know she can.
Yeah.
I don't want to say a bad word.
Yeah, I'm happy I have cords between me.
Oh, and they win the chair,
I
too.
I want this side of the table for
yeah,
a reason.
Yeah, the chair. The chair is also up for grabs.
Well, also, Nevada is the only one with a truck here.
Only
right?
One.
So she could take
home.
The chair home.
So yeah, she kind of has to win.
Let's load her up in her big
so that Ted and Storm can get rid
can
of the
get
chair.
Get rid of that nasty green chair.
Why do you, that's a nice chair, dude.
Do you want it for your house?
Where is it going to go?
Wow. On top, Wacey, on top of your coat.
Wacey, how many dates did you go on with last year's Bachelor winner?
Oh, we hung out like a handful of times, I'd say.
Okay.
So a real date's one?
Would you do something no. different this time around that you did with the last one that maybe didn't work out so well?
I would say no because I went on about it. Like I've made an effort to like hang out and do stuff, but then she like turned it around on me to where she didn't want whatever was happening.
She just
I don't know. I took the same approach that I do with every girl that I meet and I like, and it didn't work.
So. You just fell right in love.
Do you know what love was in the air?
Foip.
We're getting sued again.
Boys, we're getting foip.
Love was on the air. Okay.
Love's
any
in
last,
the air today though.
Any
Let's
last
go.
Thoughts? Before we,
what do you guys think? What's your guys?
Dustin, you go ahead.
I just want to say that, you know, for the girls that are sitting back there right now, I hope that this is like, if you are selected and you get a date, like, take the moment and seize it. Seize the moment.
Seize.
Because, you know, Wacey is truly, despite that we roast Wacey and like, he is
the best
fallen
guy.
In love and had his heart broken. He is truly like a genuine, super good guy.
Thank you.
And like, he is a good friend. And he would make a great partner.
A great friend.
Great partner. And whoever
I'm
gets that rose,
I'm still not convinced
that
you two are. Yeah. Yeah. Wait,
are you going to move
really,
in with him? Yeah.
Are you going to really...
Wait, so you take my rose?
Are you, yeah.
I brought my own rose.
Yeah. No, but Wacey's
a super... We're
going to
see some major turntables here, and you just select Dustin as the winner?
Teddy, what do you think?
What do I think?
Yeah, what's your what do you have to say?
My thoughts are that Allie should get this Toblerone rose because she was really set on it beforehand.
Hell yeah!
Thanks for being part of the show. Congratulations on finding love.
Are you going to throw any more of your?
You have to share that with Dustin.
And I hope we can do a podcast from the wedding.
Are you going to do any commercials?
Yeah, like, do you have anything else to ask Allie before the end of the show here, Dustin?
Is it sparkly,
Allie?
Don't do this.
She yearns.
You're
going to
make me yearn.
Allie, will you?
She yearns. Is that what you said?
Yeah. Because he makes all these jokes.
She's
like,
pining.
The other night, he's like, wheels are in motion. What wheels?
We were in Jamaica this winter on a trip.
Sandals, and
we jumped into this blue Jamaica. Lagoon at hot, night. Hot, it was hot. Like midnight.
It was sketchy.
And some people thought I might propose to her in Jamaica. And I swam up to her and we were just by ourselves in the water.
And I was scared.
I said, Allie, there's something I need to ask you. And she's like, oh my God.
No,
like,
I didn't.
Will you come back to the resort with me on the bus?
You said, will you sit beside me on the bus? And I'm
as a freshly engaged guy, which...
Yeah, how'd you do it?
So
I'm just going to say the one piece...
I thought you were last time.
You have to be very careful for being a practical joker because when I did it, I kind of practically did a couple practical jokes on it earlier. But when I did it, she turned around and looked and I was on one knee and she looked at me very much in my eyes, loving, and said... that better not be a pair of fucking earrings.
That's so Preston, I said that. I said to Dustin, I'm like, you have to stop joking about it, because if you ever actually do it, I won't believe you.
Yeah.
She emailed me some ring pictures.
You
last
asked
week.
For them.
All right, let's get off this.
All right, hey, okay. Teddy, you're up.
Ted, what do you think?
Wace, I hope you find love today, but if you don't, it's okay, because we'll do season 3 next year.
It's good for ratings.
Yeah, it's okay. All right, we're going to be back with this.
Preston, what about Preston?
Oh, sorry. Go ahead. I think you just did your
what
thing.
Do you have to say?
I think that Wace is, I think this is the year. I really ditto Dustin on that the winner should take it a little bit. Take it seriously. This is great that the women are coming out this far and they're doing this, throwing themselves out there. But Wacey takes a pretty large beating at this for Teddy's rating.
Yeah, hey, it's a team show. We're in this together here. So.
Even if he has those pants on.
Yeah, it's okay.
Love the pants.
All right,
my pants are sweet, dude.
After this, the finale of The Bachelor season 2.
Dun dun. Dun.
Come on, girl. Yeah. It's me, Jackie Murray. Oh, give me that look. That's right. Let's get sweaty. Let's get real sweaty. I'm talking rainforest sweaty. I'm talking swamp sweaty. Let's fill the bathtub full of sweat.
That's what this was. All right. Oh, I didn't grab one, sorry. Wants to love and sex.
I'm nervous.
The final countdown.
It started with 4, but only one will receive the rose.
After
will one
this.
Girl get a green card?
Okay. Will one get a new employee?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Will a Western store inherit a greeter? Will one contestant receive a green card?
Will the Western Stockman receive a stock boy?
Will the Bronc Rider have a spotter in Winfield?
Will there be a study buddy in the room?
In Red Deer.
Find out next on The Bachelor.
Let me pull your back cinch.
Okay, Wace, comes down to this.
All right, so again, I just want to thank everybody for coming out. This has been fun. It's not easy to do.
So you're going to start picking them off one by one, right?
Yeah, so I'm going to work my way down.
So like, you're going to say, in fourth place.
You don't have to go home when he says
fourth place. Out. Yeah, you can still watch the football game.
Oh, so how about
if you want to take the chair on your way out.
So I'm going to pick my top two.
I'm going to go.
And then for my top two, I'll pick
you're
going to
pick your top two?
Yeah.
So then the other two, just they got to scram.
Yeah, just,
you scram.
Well, it's not, you know,
just, you just they
don't
go sit in Ted's bedroom.
They don't have to scram. Just,
you guys can just go stand by the buffalo head?
Well, I'm not sure. I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings either. I'm really conscientious of other people's feelings. I'm like,
you don't want to say fourth. That's kind of mean.
We need to have the survivor, like, flame
the
things.
Tribe has
hold on.
And you put
hold
a cup
on.
Over
what
them.
You could do is you could say two girls' names and say, I'm sorry, you're not in the top two.
Hold on.
Yeah, goodbye.
Here we go.
Oh, you got this music for us?
Give me a second.
Here we go.
Give me a second here.
Here we go. Ready?
Ad come in here. Stand oh, no, we're good.
Tribe is about to speak.
My heart rate's gone up a lot.
Okay. So, my top two, gonna have to go with Nevada, Paige.
Top two? How does your two? First impression?
Man, that just you can't tell me what
oh,
I think,
wow.
Dude.
Wow. I can't tell him how to feel. It's what it is.
I did a lot of. Wow. I did a lot. I took a long look in the mirror. I did some self reflecting.
Combed your hair.
I'm gonna be sick.
What did you say, Lace?
You're gonna be sick.
I'm nervous.
You buddy, didn't pick Lacey with the puppy.
Pins and needles.
I'm sore.
Do you have
I'm
a heart?
I'm so okay.
Look at how sad.
Okay, wait. Okay, to the two girls who didn't make the top two, I apologize. You're both wonderful women.
You're never getting hired at Western Stockman.
Darn.
You're going to fail university.
Don't ask for a discount. Never happening. You're paying full prices in Lethbridge.
I wear Levi's anyways. But yeah, I once again, I apologize. I thank you for making
Paige
the trip.
Paige in Nevada, please step forward.
Oh, you guys, they got to hold hands.
The,
just like,
can I have the rose?
You will now arm wrestle to see who wins Wacey's heart.
No, I think it should be a leg wrestle.
Leg wrestle. Yeah. Like leg wrestle. All right.
Okay, here we go. Here we go, Wacey.
I've never been more.
Do we got another song? Do we got another song?
Yeah, you're going to build it up. What's the next one? Give me a build. I don't, give me some drama.
Oh,
here we go. Here we go.
God, this is such a good song.
My life is brilliant.
It's okay if you cry, Wace. This is a podcast. Getting, no one can
I'm
see
I'm getting
you.
Quite emotional. And I'm a confirmed crier on the podcast.
Let's go back to the kitchen where Wacey will make his
the dining room.
Finding love in the kitchen again.
Once again, thank you both you ladies for coming out. Ah, man, this is hard.
That's what she said.
Yeah, title of my sex name.
Oh, dear.
Okay. May surprise some people here.
Oh, but surprise, surprise.
Paige, will you accept my final Toblerone?
Is this where you guys kiss?
Kiss her! Kiss
Go
her!
On and kiss the girl.
That's what, yeah, we did it. Dance party.
Kiss her.
I'm not kissing her. I'm going to give her a hug.
Give her a kiss.
Thank you. Yeah, we did it. I got to give hugs to her.
She's getting a green card. We should have known the rodeo queen would get the rose.
Royalty always wins.
I break it down. You guys want to break it down?
Yeah, I'm gonna break it down here.
Hey,
Paige, jump back on the
mic. Paige, jump on his lap here.
Yeah. God, we have to break this down. I need to know where this answer came from.
No, I'm trying.
Oh, share the
chair. Sit on his lap. Sit on the
chair. Share the chair.
You might get some lines on your legs from my corduroys.
Oh, I love those corduroys.
So, Storm, you actually called this like right off the bat. You thought that Paige was gonna fall in love with Wacey, and that was how it was gonna be. What it was gonna.
She needs a mic.
Yeah, that was what that was, you called this from the very beginning, though, didn't you?
I did. I did call this from the very beginning.
Well done.
So, for those who don't know who Storm is, this is Ted's girlfriend.
She's real.
Yeah. This is my podcast
Her
debut.
Podcast appearance. We mentioned her a lot in the show.
Friend of the show.
Yeah. Really?
All the way from Herbert, Saskatchewan.
She likes orange sherbet.
Orange sherbet from Herbert.
And Christmas oranges as well.
Oh.
Yeah.
A little tidbit for everyone back home.
So, put that down. I can't wait to see the picture from the strawberry and cream festival this summer.
I like strawberries.
I want Wacey, the picture of Wacey in front of her on the horse.
Guess who's doubling at the NFR?
At the NFR. On the front.
You know, I always set out a dream. I had a dream of mine to make the NFR as a kid. Yeah. And I finally found my way in.
maybe crack a latch or two there.
Yeah. So can we talk about the visa situation?
Should we get the paperwork rolling?
I know. You want to get your minister papers ready to go? Want to go print them off?
We got border services outside.
I got us a reservation at Ranchman's for the wedding tonight.
Yeah, it turns out we know where to get a dress.
Is the godfather?
Actually, is the godfather, Callie's got one.
Is the godfather going to cater that?
The dogfather.
The dogfather.
Get it right.
Hot dog father.
Hot dogs for everybody.
So when do you fly out? Wednesday?
Yes.
So you won't make Mamma Mia Thursday.
The Flames play Tuesday, baby.
Let's go.
She
wants to go to a Flames game.
Oh, there you go. Okay, Wace.
Is that
going to
be a
sorrowful
goodbye?
I'm going to cry a little bit. Yep.
Yeah. So you're going to move downtown now? You're going to the downtown division?
Downtown, yeah. Calgary.
Yeah.
Would you consider making a move to Alberta?
I'm not opposed.
Mm. So you're saying there's a chance.
This is the first...
One in a million.
What's the first international...
A guy like you and a girl like me getting together.
International love affair on the podcast. This is big for the program.
We're reaching
numerous countries.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Something.
Any last thoughts before we wrap things up here?
No, I'm excited.
Is it true love? Are you in love?
Yes, Ted, I am.
You know, Teddy,
do you have something to say right now?
I think that this process was pretty intense this year. Like, I actually was feeling pretty pins and needles. I don't know if I'm just hungover, if that was the problem. I know I am, but I don't know, Dustin, you feel like love's in the air now?
Love is in the air. Take it from someone who found love. I can see something here. I can see some sparks.
In a hopeless place.
In a hopeless place. I see it. I like it.
Okay.
This is beautiful.
Thanks to everyone for listening to The Bachelor Season 2. Congratulations, Wacey and Paige.
We'll be back here next year. On a night.